Hey, welcome to Thursday Night Throwdown, Giant Bomb's weekly community game night. I'm Ryan Davis. Jeff Gerstmann's on the far end of this very long couch.
I'm all over here.
Doesn't look as long in the shot. You got to put your leg down. Put your leg down. There we go. Look at all this expansive space for you.
This is where you are.
This is you are joining us.
The metaphorical you.
In the center spot.
Are here to play some Mod Nation Racers
some
with
damn
us.
Damn Mod Nation Racers. Jeff, let's damn get into the damn game already.
Whoa.
If you're...
Salty.
If you're watching and you want to play with us, GBTNT is the name on the account. I don't know that I'll be able to accept any new friend requests.
All one thinger?
All, yeah.
No spaces?
Nope. No spaces. I don't think that matters on the PS3.
Okay.
Let's cut to the race. Let's cut to my mod spot. As you can see, I am rocking the General Lee.
You racist.
One of many luchadors. That are in Mod Nation Racers, and already my lobby full of friends.
Now, this isn't really a lobby. This is just when you're in the mod spot, it kind of randomly groups you with dudes, so you can dude it up. I don't know what dudes do.
It's a mystery to everyone, Jeff. Should we go and like look at some mod stuff and cart stuff?
Well, yeah, you've already downloaded a bunch of stuff. Why don't we
go to the creation station?
Yeah, maybe download some more. I think just at any point where you're driving around that mod spot, you pop up a little poppet kind of thing and change your dude.
Oh, I don't have to go here.
I don't know that you have to go in here, but we can.
But here we can download stuff.
Yeah.
Here's my mod. My dog.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, there's a bunch of them. You want to see some of the others?
Sure.
So that's a V2. This is V1. I don't know, I kind of like... Well, let's compare it again here. I kind of like V1 better.
Well, you know,
I kind of like the shirt.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. And here's another one. It's a little gnarlier here. It's got bull horns.
Whoa.
But I don't know, an acceptable interpretation.
Yeah.
And here's just, I guess... Giant Bomb. Jefficus.
Okay, yeah.
That works. And then, you know, other copyrighted characters like Inspector Gadget.
That's great. Well,
or. That's
pretty
good.
I don't know about the antennas. I guess you gotta. Yeah, I guess I see what they're going for with the antennas. Alright.
That's a pretty good Skeletor.
We're not hacking websites. Skeletor is racing. Hearts.
All right, here's what we're going to do, Jeff. I have some exciting news for you.
All right. That's not
right. We've got Optimus Prime here.
Okay. That's,
right?
Yeah.
Pretty good. Decent.
Decent little Optimus Prime.
Decent Optimus Prime. I don't know. I want to go there. I want to go to carts. We'll select a cart from here. And I will select Optimus Prime.
What?
Optimus Prime is going to drive Optimus Prime.
That doesn't work.
Well, let's see what happens.
Oh, man.
When I leave
You're about to crash the PlayStation Network.
The whole thing's coming down.
Yep.
It's worth noting, Jeff, Matt Kessler, intern Matt Kessler, is manning the chat room for us here.
Sure am, Ryan.
Making sure... I hadn't actually thrown to you yet.
That's
sure
okay. We didn't give him a mic this week.
That's right.
So.
That's true. Smart of us. Making sure the chat doesn't get too rowdy and also funneling us questions. Although Jeff and I, probably the worst people to answer questions about.
Ask me everything.
Ask Jeff. Jeff will field all your questions. And there you are, Jeff, in all its glory.
Oh, man.
Optimus Prime on Optimus Prime action.
It's like one of them needs to be Ultra Magnus for this to work.
It would be like the manbabies.com, except if it was both your head on the baby and you. All right, let's go. You want a race?
Let's fire up a race. Let's get some races going. You downloaded some tracks as well?
I did. Most kind of just went through like what's popular, what's hot, and it's a lot of garbage.
Great.
A lot of
like
kind
this
of
one for
gaming,
getting
like,
trophies and
yeah, like a lot of trophy getting stuff.
Waluigi Stadium.
But then there's stuff like this. This is clearly not garbage. We will do Waluigi Stadium, despite my hatred of Waluigi. 9 laps seems like a lot.
It does.
Like 3?
How about 3?
Pro. Pro's the middle speed class.
What's the highest? Is it?
It's Elite.
Whoa.
I'm not going to go Elite.
All right, start with Pro.
Action race, pure race, action race. And we will do full 12 visibility. This is private. This is for friends only.
That's right. Oh, load screen. Oh, that's nice.
Just a little bit. Yeah. Just a little bit. No, we get our grand load screen later on here. Is there an easier way for me to do this? Can I just... Is there any way I could send group? Nope. All right. Let me just do it this way. You get an invite. And you get an invite.
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff, remember last week when we did Team Fortress 2?
Oh, barely. Now that you mention it, I do remember that.
But if I hadn't mentioned that, you would have already forgotten that?
Yeah, probably.
That was pretty awesome, because we didn't have to do this.
Yeah. PC games don't... Oh, are you full? Or is that guy doing something else, or was he not?
Gangly monster. I don't know. Let's see if... I guess, no, where are we?
We must be full up.
We must be...
Yeah.
Swole. Okay, well, maybe I don't have to invite everyone. Maybe they can just gang in.
Yeah.
We'll start the race.
Okay. And sinking then, tracks.
Sink tracks.
I do really like the idea of this game with, you know, just creating tracks, creating carts, creating dudes. Like, it's...
just infinite content. And it handles really well, too.
Yeah,
I will say that about Mod Nation Races.
Yeah.
It's got a smart, fun, fast, loose handling model that's just like... It is kart racing. It is what you think of when you think of that.
There's a boost start, you know, all that stuff.
All right, now, Jeff, sit back, relax, enjoy a little loading. Matt Kessler, manning the chat room, you want to throw some questions Jeff's way?
Throwing to me?
Yes.
I have permission. All right.
No one can hear anything you're saying, so don't worry.
No! All right. How are the load times, Jeff?
Jeff, how are the load times? Who's that from?
Everyone.
I don't answer anonymous question. Okay, everyone wants to know. The load times are lengthy.
Oh wait, now we can't see how long the load time is.
There's some load times in this game. Yeah.
Well, now it's starting.
Lengthy to the point where we're gonna be coming back to us a lot.
A Kool-Aid Man's here!
Load.
I love the PlayStation 3's lack of respect for copyright law.
Yeah, I mean, you know,
they kinda
policed Little Big Planet here and there, but this just seems rampant and flagrant and unrepentant. Three ants.
Oh, yes.
And we were racing.
12 racers. This may be more bedlam than I was bargained for.
And you were bargaining for a fair amount.
Indeed.
And you drive a hard bargain.
All right.
Where's
the track going? Where is the track?
Yeah, this is... Waluigi is a bastard. Okay, this is a left turn.
We knew that. Going in. For sure. Is that Will Smith joining us?
That is Will Smith joining us.
Television's own Will Smith?
Clipping on a microphone.
Oh.
And then he threw the microphone away.
Boosting. Oh, no!
Look out for that.
Doesn't it?
No, he's playing... Yeah, he's playing his Optimus Prime driving Optimus Prime.
Oh no!
Which is disgusting.
Hey, you know what? It's the only way I can get off anymore.
Yeah. We were just saying it is rampant copyright violations. All of one guy is driving as the Kool-Aid Man.
Yep. Here's another.
Oh no!
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! Pretty much. Just we're gonna give you the tools to make all the stuff we couldn't license.
This
is actually a track from Mario Kart.
Yeah, we're playing. This is a Waluigi track.
This is the arena.
Oh god.
Nice.
I'm not gonna say nice because I'm 11 out of 11.
I was gonna say try not to place last. That's that is after all the giant bomb motto.
It's the giant bomb suggestion.
Giant bomb, we're better than last place.
That's right. We're not in last.
Oh no!
Oh my god. I played a lot of Mario Kart over the years. I don't recognize this track. Is it the one that's
well,
in...
It's a Waluigi brand named track, so I'm going to assume that this is...
pretty late model Mario Kart, Double Dash or newer.
Maybe GameCube.
Maybe Double Dash.
Yeah, I never got into Double Dash. That's the only one I didn't play a lot of.
I maintain that everyone's favorite Mario Kart is the first Mario Kart they ever played. It is Disney-like.
That is... I agree with you, but I think the N64 version is my favorite.
I think that is my least favorite.
Really?
Yeah.
Because well, it was the first one that had ups and downs.
It was definitely the most disappointing. I remember we were very excited about getting that game in the office, and then the day it showed up, we probably played it for about 45 minutes and just went, ugh.
See, I played it two players a lot, and four players
we were playing
a little.
We were playing a lot of four.
I could see how the quarter wouldn't have worked as well.
Maybe.
What do you think about the Wii version? Not so much?
No interest. Yeah, I did play a fair amount of it, and I think the wheel was real silly.
I'm not sure what that is.
Yeah.
Kart racing...
You move beyond it. You're in a world past kart racing?
Yeah, I think so. I do like the way this game handles and stuff. I think they do some cool stuff with it. And the way they handle like the power-ups on weapons and stuff. Like you collect multiple types of the same weapon and you get three different levels for each power-up that way.
So instead of having more of something, it just gets better and better?
Yeah.
Nice. I do like that.
10th!
Nice going.
10th!
Unofficial result. We're waiting to hear
from the judges
this
say?
Photo finish.
Illegal copyright infringement?
Yeah, it's like, Double Optimus is not permitted.
It seems like if you look that up on the internet, there's probably some sort of something really obscene.
See, I'm saying 3 stars. That was okay. Yeah. It was a little confusing. You know, maybe it's just not great for 12 people. Or 11 people, as it were. It just wasn't ideal.
Do you guys feel like it's important that we rate everything now? In the whole world?
No, not really. But I do it.
Yeah, it's just all the stuff is user-created, so they have to do it to somehow make all their sorts work.
So you don't end up with the situation where like the level that gets you the most points the fastest.
That totally is the situation. There's basically the equivalent of an achievement server as one of the top tracks. So
that's when I stopped playing Little Big Planet Online.
Yeah. Whatever, that's when I started because it was the first day. Someone had one of those. I was like, oh great, this actually makes
get
this
every
really
achievement
easy.
In one slide.
Awesome. Okay, I'm gonna say play a different track.
Yeah.
Try a different track. Race settings.
There we go.
Don't be
edit
racist.
Settings,
edit
guys.
Settings.
There we go.
Let's try.
I like to look at that mad spiral.
Let's try. No.
No, it's
not.
We'll
do that later.
Okay.
At some point, but Speed Mario Trophy.
Mario Andretti, you think, or you know, a different Mario?
Who can say, really? Legally, who can say?
Yeah. Is there a giant castle in this map, perhaps?
There is no global best lap time for this, so I'm wary. At 7 seconds is the best lap time for this race.
Seems like it's very short.
What?
There's a jump.
Egypt. 55 seconds. 3 laps. Pro. Yeah. Let's keep trucking.
Yeah.
Literally. I'm a truck.
So are the load times as bad as everybody bitched about?
You're about to experience them for yourself.
I'm looking forward to it. This is my first Mod Nation.
Point one, the race, our countdown now, this is not a load time. This is a preload load time.
Wow.
This is warming you up for the load time.
So
this is like the running grab a beer time, basically.
Sure.
For a kid's kind of kart racing game.
Right. Yeah.
Well, who have we got here? We've got a
Captain Canada.
Kool-Aid Man. We've got a Killzone dude. We have, I don't know what the yellow guy is.
I think he's a race car driver.
Hey, that's
Hello,
us.
Internet
hey.
People.
I like that you waved at the TV. You waved
at that's me.
No, it's
I'm
over there.
That's me
where
in the mirror.
Waving. Matt Kessler. While we wait for this load time to load, what's up with the chat going on?
Here's the question I want you to ask Jeff.
Jeff, there's a question for you from the chat.
All right, I'm ready for questions.
Is Giant Bomb planning on suing the creators of these fine Luchador and Luchadier and Giant Bomb characters for Foundation Breaks?
Mackesler has a terrible question for you.
Yeah, that's the most boring question ever.
But I've forgotten what the question is.
I'm going to talk to our legal counsel about these bootleg Luchadiers in this game, and we're basically, I figure by this time tomorrow, we'll own most of Sony. So whatever first-party Sony games you want to be in development, hit us up. We'll be able to make that happen.
So. Is this Lincoln Force? Is that what I'm hearing?
Yeah,
it's going to be a PS3 exclusive?
Lincoln Force is coming to PSP Minis.
Okay.
As a prelude to the full console game.
And the C64.
Yeah, and the Commodore 64. Which we won the rights to that in a weird lawsuit with the Tremils fairly recently about all the emotional scarring that we all experienced during the Jaguar days.
You seem to be hitting the walls a lot, Ryan. I don't want to judge.
It's true. I am.
But the general theory on these games is if you go faster, if you don't hit things, right?
This map is if we want to talk theoretical, sure.
Right. I think in the real world, if you got that much air and landed on the ground, you'd probably die.
If you were Optimus Prime, though?
Maybe not
in Optimus
Prime.
Right. Double Prime?
The double Prime might save you. You want it, kids, right?
I think it's great that you turn on subtitles for all this amazingly witty commentary to this game.
I wasn't sure what the subtitles were for.
Maybe it's like a Left 4 Dead thing where you get cues.
Yeah.
Right? Somebody's about to pass you as they pass you.
Yeah, moving there.
Green fire is good, right?
Yeah, okay. Always.
Smoke.
Do you think there's room in the kart genre to like revolutionize this entire type of game?
Well, that's kind of what Blur was, you know?
Kind of.
Or at least that was their intent.
Yeah, they took all the power-ups and basic mechanics of a kart racing game and applied to licensed cars and all the other stuff. I mean, they basically just made it Wipeout at that point. Which made me realize that Wipeout is totally a kart racing game.
Wipeout is, it's a fast kart racing game.
Yeah, it's just faster and better design.
Yes. I'm terrible at Wipeout, traditionally.
I had my... I was pretty good at Wipeout for a while.
Like the PlayStation version of Wipeout.
Wipeout XL. Yeah. The second one. Good
Wipeout. Back when it was awesome.
Wipeout HD, however, is a pretty
that's phenomenal.
Terrific game.
It seems just like Wipeout XL, but with slightly better maps and everything
like,
in
like
HD.
Way better graphics, and frame rate, and all that stuff. Like the sense of speed's terrific.
Soundtrack's not as good.
Yeah.
Needs more Chemical Brothers.
Yeah. More Firestarter instrumental. Needs more Red Bull ads. Matt, I would love a question from the chat. Lay it forth.
Bill Mills wants to know if you're not a fan of track racer, kart racers, how do you feel about Trackmania?
So the question was, if I don't like kart racing games, how do I feel about Trackmania? I love Trackmania. It's not a kart racing game.
It's just a racing game.
Yeah,
right?
It's pretty much a racing game. But even then, it's just a crazy racing game with ridiculous tracks and. In kind of the default time attack mode, you don't even collide with other racers. You're just kind of on the track with them at the same time. You kind of drive through them ghost style, and whoever has the fastest time at the end of 5 minutes wins.
That was some needle thread in there, Brian. Don't think we didn't notice.
Thank you, I appreciate it. It was tough.
Yeah, you've really steered your way to last place quite well.
Now
that everyone isn't constantly shooting me, it's a lot easier.
You're one spiny shell away from first if this is Mario Kart. Wall. Just start saying wall every time you hit a wall.
You do have that turbo as well.
I know, like, I don't really want to use it right now.
You're saving it for getting out of last place?
I'll save it for when I'm not in a bunch of turns.
Oh, okay. That's smart.
Here. Hey, Vinny's coming back. Guys, I came in last place.
I think it's the map. You should give this map one star. I think you need a map that's just a straight line with no fences.
That sounds good.
A drag race car game. Why are there no drag racing games?
There are. They're bad.
Yeah,
it's just a sport that doesn't.
It's all this like weird budget PC developers from foreign countries making. Yeah.
Like we paid a dollar for the IHRA license, and now.
Now we're shaking the ground with funny car power.
Alcohol burning or nitrous?
Alcohol, definitely.
This is league play after all.
Yeah.
Okay. So are there ladders and stuff in this, or is it a? You know, can you be the best?
No, it's carts, not. It's not chutes and ladders. Oh. It's carts.
Oh, I thought it was snakes and ladders.
Nope.
Interesting.
You're misinformed.
Why don't we try some of the tracks that came with the games? We'll know that those will be all right.
Sure, we know those will work.
But they're not going to be like Mario Kart tracks that we're familiar with.
Like those last two that I did so well in because of my familiarity.
This is true. Your Mario Kart expertise may be failing.
Yeah, Breakwater. Way. Sure, that sounds good.
Rumble Island.
I want to see a track with some water that you can fall into.
Cows are always good.
Farm Frenzy.
Reminds me of 12 seconds.
Maybe it's just people cheating or something weird like that. I wouldn't worry too much about it.
All right.
Yeah, people.
There's no way the official tracks have lap times of 2 seconds.
People are probably hacking.
Damn it, people. Why you gotta be like that? And Solid Snake has joined us.
I like that. Is he going to drive around in a cardboard box? Because that would be awesome.
That would be pretty awesome.
We'll find out soon enough. And is that upper right? Is that the ninja?
The Metal Gear ninja?
Yeah.
I don't know. From here, it almost looks like Spawn or something.
I can kind of see that. I also kind of see like Power Ranger. Kind of Power Rangers.
They seem to be back on TV for the load screen. It seems like these load screens go incredibly fast.
Yeah.
When we're sitting here looking at ourselves.
And you didn't wave at yourself this time.
Hi!
So way better.
Hello.
Now that time you waved at the camera, not at yourself. It was way
Jeff's
better.
Jeff's gone!
It was way better.
Wow. We reached a new low here, I think.
How do you mean?
Well, I just held my hand up in front of Jeff's face and was like, Jeff's gone. That was when it went sideways. I'm not getting love from the chat.
That was when the business took a turn. Gotta pack up our stuff and be out.
I hardly noticed the load time there.
It's because you were entertained by your own image.
I thought you were gonna make Bodega dance during the.
We should just replace the TV with a mirror.
This
if you did that,
great.
I'd never leave this room.
Constantly batting at it.
Nice takeoff.
Thank you. I didn't do anything.
You're inside. Never mind. Well, holding strong hold on second to last place.
Yeah.
Coming to the third turn.
This is great because soon other people are going to be playing this game instead of me. Like
Do you have to make sparks in this game like with Mario Kart, or is there a different strategy?
You earn boost by drifting, I believe.
Okay.
So that meter on the right fills up when you do things.
But
so.
It's not an immediate
right.
Like, Mario
yeah,
Kart.
You control when you want to boost.
Okay. Like there was a kind of frame rate hitch there. Is this a game where you use the brake or not so much?
Not so much.
Not too much. My limited experience.
My basic rule on racing games is I don't play games that you have to use the brake.
I was like you once, but then I enjoyed Forza Motorsport 3 too much.
Oh, and you learned. Well, it had the line to tell you when to use the brake.
Yeah.
I did like Forza.
I'm going to turn him off.
Ryan, he just said that you were like low-handing it this matchup, is what I heard.
You might want to shoot those rockets. I think they might home in.
Yeah, the red ones usually are home. Wow, that is a lot of rockets.
Do you like my rockets?
I'm trying to find some rockets. Yeah, see, you hit some dudes. Nice.
You killed a leprechaun, dude.
Yeah, you blazed those guys.
Pretty disturbing.
And your boost meter's full.
He's coming up Millhouse.
I guess in addition to being a boost meter, it's also your shield, right?
Oh.
I'm going to say yes.
Yeah. Why not? Okay.
I'm going to say that is the case.
Wall.
Yeah.
You're in sixth place. This is your best joint. I'm not going to say anything.
Yeah, it's hard.
I don't want to jinx it. That is a very improbable jump.
I like
not
the,
for Optimus Prime.
That's where this is all losing it for you, not the truck driving a truck.
I like the truck driving a truck. It's a... Uh-oh. That was close. Looks like you just dropped a bomb, dude.
Blew up that boat.
Oh god.
Oh my god. The
that is...
I should not have ran into that.
And
edge.
Then... Oh boy, the swarm of rockets.
And then 11.
Back to your custom position.
It is a kart racing game. So, you know, big swings kind of right. built in.
If you're not first, you're last, Ryan. That's all I know. Is it the big heads that makes it... Uh-oh. Oh, that was close. Oh, wow.
I just lost my truck entirely that time.
Luckily, you can turn back into a truck.
You are a truck without a truck.
Ninth.
Boom. That's not bad. You're getting better.
I feel pretty good about that.
The chat would like to point out that that friendly announcer guy is totally the announcer from Crackdown 2.
I was going to say, he sounded like the Crackdown guy for a little bit there.
Which makes this whole game much darker.
I wish that there were orbs to collect in this game.
There are. Power-up orbs.
Yeah, but you don't have to jump all over the place and go into crazy buildings. And...
You kind of have to go off the main track sometimes.
That's true. That's true.
The parallels between Mod Nation Racers and the Crackdown franchise abound!
Pretty much really, the same game.
They kind of break down after we get past the announcer and the balls.
I don't see it. How do you mean?
Well, you know, that's about having superpowers. And while you can dress up like somebody who has superpowers...
You just said that I did a bunch of jumps that would have killed me.
That's true.
Does that not sound pretty super to you?
Sounds pretty super now that you mention it. Now I feel,
now that I
feel,
I mention,
I feel
now
ashamed.
Now that I mention it.
I'm just going to sit here and be quiet and drink a beverage.
Very good. Should I, you know what? Let's mix it up some here.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
What should I drive?
Oh, please tell me that's the mystery machine.
Yeah, that is. I have the mystery machine, I got the A-team van, I got the General Lee, I got the Mach 1, and I have this mail van.
Mach 5.
What did I say?
Is it
Mach 1.
Oh,
it's
Mach 5, thank you.
It's an M-A-I-L van, though.
It's not the kind you like, I know.
Are you going to dress up like Cliff Clavin and get in there?
Nope, I will be Skeletor.
On this week's episode of Copyright Infringement Theater.
In a USPS.
It's just straight up like Quake 2. It's like, check out this Batman model and skin I made.
I'm playing as Mr. Burns.
They never really looked right.
Yeah, they never did.
And it was always like, yeah.
Like, what can you do with this hitbox?
Yeah.
Well.
But now they look so much righter.
Yeah, now it's just like, it's like they're really here with us.
I always wonder what it would be like if Skeletor was secretly a mailman. Now I know.
Are you starting a race on the same track?
No, I changed to Rumble Island.
Oh, I thought that's what we did last time. Okay.
No, it was Breakwater.
Okay.
People are sitting
there. Is there a soccer game happening outside?
I don't know.
I'm
going to get a
sounds like
wailing.
Zombie Nation is being chanted out there. Yes.
That's what happens when you have a bar in your office.
Loading screen.
Yeah, the mistake with the bar in the office is that we, you know, like 2 o'clock, everybody's in there.
They go.
Gotta get an eye open.
Post noon, time to hit the bar.
Yeah, a little post lunch nip just to get me back in the mood for coding. That's what they always say.
See, I don't find it's that. It's more of like the 4:45, like just before 5 o'clock, people kind of start.
I just like to pretend I'm in Mad Men,
hanging out further and further and closer and closer to the bar.
What's gonna happen is the booze is gonna make its way out of the bar, and pretty soon you'll just open your drawer and be like, "Hey, you want a scotch?"
I hope not. I really. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. You know what? I will sacrifice this race.
This is I don't see how Skeletor can see there, dude.
What did you? Why did you? Oh, so yeah.
that and then also. All right.
Okay.
Ixnay on the announcer. Nay.
Worth
it. Ryan, principle are more important than winning.
Well, winning is the subjective.
I wasn't going to win anyway, so, you know.
Well, now you have your pride.
Now, that's a kind of Kessler attitude. I'm not going to win anyway.
He's rubbing off on me.
I do like that you intentionally avoided the balls there, though.
Power-ups, that's cheap.
I have a power-up already.
That's true.
But you power up the power-ups.
But can I know what power-up I'm going to pick up?
Aren't they all, once you pick up one, don't you just keep, get to keep using more and more?
I think that might be the case. It's been a while.
It's been less than 2 months.
Okay. Oh, wow, that was close.
Cripple Captain asks, Will, provide race commentary. Go!
He's coming to the seventh turn, and there's some skulls and a wall.
Skulls. I like skulls.
That looks like someplace that you would get mashed if you were closer to the pack. I don't know. Never seen this before. And we're coming into the... I'm waiting to see some more competitors here.
I was going to say, this is not the kind of race commentary that Will Smith is used to.
I'm more of a kind of, you know, skateboard down the mountain. Actually, I've never done race commentary before in my life. Hard to believe.
You're so good.
Hit your level 3 warp. See what it does.
Yes.
It's not going to get of a higher level than that.
Whoa.
So.
You warped
there you go. Huh?
Wow.
How's that?
You're almost winning. Oh, the master is almost matched. Potango with a smooth move on the inside.
They must be playing NBA Jam back there. That must be why they're all shouting.
We should do an NBA Jam TNT.
Yeah. Do these cameras reach out there?
I don't know. We get cords.
Cords, huh?
Wires? This is a new thing.
You guys, your tech sites and your wires.
Just because we like to connect things doesn't mean we're already better than us. And Skeletor left the mail truck. I feel like if I could see more of the track, I could probably commentate a little better.
Oh, wall. You're saying this game needs a spectator view?
I mean, I'm just saying I need a spectator view. Does this do the shame end, where if you're not close enough to the finish, that's sad. So Ryan's in a desperate, desperate race. Yes!
Hooray!
You finished.
Congratulations.
It's all about collecting that mail.
I think that was probably the mail truck's fault, if I had to guess.
It was probably like the good 10 to 15 seconds I spent at the beginning of the race not racing. If I had to guess.
It's a kart racing game, dude. That doesn't matter. There's always a warp to push you ahead.
You were 14 seconds behind the leader, so you probably would have won that race had you not stopped.
I'm pretty sure you spent 16 seconds on the menus. At least.
All right, do we want to dump out and get another crew in here?
TJ311 would like you to dump that group.
Yeah, sure.
I think I'm going to dump out.
Well, so leave the room first.
Alexander Hemsley and Sneaky Badger.
The Sneaky Badger?
The sneakiest of badgers.
Wait, hold on. Is he the Sneaky Badger or is he the sneakiest badger?
Well, he's a pretty sneaky badger.
I wouldn't have guessed badgers to be very sneaky.
Badgers are mad sneaky.
Really?
Yeah.
Is this like a Wind in the Willows thing, or is this some basis in badger reality?
It's like wizard familiar badgers.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Burrow, dude. Underground. I guess I didn't realize that badgers were burrowers.
You learn something new every week here on the Thursday Night Throwdown. Yeah,
that's right. It's not just fun and games.
Well, it's not fun and games.
It's not fun and games. Are there any lava tracks? I feel like lava could add something to this game.
President Barakbar asks, is Jeff Bridges in this game yet?
Probably. I could probably go search the dude.
I guarantee you there's a dude. Yeah.
That's the nice thing about that.
And the car plays Creedence when you drive.
Maybe you could find a Daft Punk robot dudes as well.
Driving the mystery machine. Yes.
Yeah. Guess what? Guess what, guys?
What?
We're going to the creation station.
Oh my god. We're going to find the dude?
I need to know now. The question has been posed. Someone wanted to know,
Is
Jeff Bridges in this game?
The other thing that the chat has asked about, including Dr. What, is Persona 4 characters. Want to look for Teddy or Chie?
They're probably all over this, but I'm not going to look for those.
That looks like Skeletor.
It's a pretty good Skeletor, right?
Not a bad Skeletor. Better than I could do.
Select mod, edit, select mod.
None of those. You want to go to download.
Right. The copyright infringement zone.
Right.
Share.
Download.
Share is another word for steal.
Indeed.
What's wrong with sharing with your friends, bro?
Dude, I'm all about sharing. Yeah, I'm from the internet.
Sharing is caring.
Oh, it's not going to be Bridges. It's going to be the dude.
I know.
Oh, this is
an experiment.
This is Bridges of Madison County.
Right. This is going to be Meryl Streep.
Tron Man. That's actually...
There you go, Indiana Jones.
That kind of looks like the dude.
Ooh. It's a little rough.
Well, I bathrobes are hard to model, it turns out.
Yeah.
Far, but far from good.
Can you get his car, is the question.
Tron Man. Let's see here. Find search? No.
No.
Oh, I wonder if someone made a light cycle. But in van form.
So it's like two light cycles glued together with a pole?
Dude seems like a really bad search term.
Yeah, you're
for
probably
this game.
Right. Yeah.
It's dude.
The dude.
We're looking for dudes in Mod Nation Racers.
Y'all got any dudes?
You know where I could find some dudes?
I'd imagine it would just ignore the word the. Maybe not. Yeah,
this is all false advertising.
This is not the dude at all.
This okay. Dude.
I guess I just need.
Maybe search for Duderino.
El Dudenator?
Yeah.
You know, under the whole brevity thing? What if
Lebanese,
you can,
that's what I need.
The thing
to
is,
for.
can you play as John Turturro? That's the real question.
You mean as the Jesus?
The Jesus. With whom you should not, well, you know.
Shut your mouth.
Why do all of these
Walter is
look like?
Walter is, Walter Sobchak is a strong, seems like Walter would do pretty well in a kart racing game.
Yeah.
With guns and things. Buddy Walter was a little disturbing, I'll be honest.
There you go, there's Jesus. The Jesus.
That's awesome.
There's another.
That Jesus is better than the first one, I think.
Here goes Donnie.
Have we talked about the Donnie hypotheses?
No, what's that?
Well, that Donnie's a fictional figment of Walter's imagination. Because the dude never talks to Donnie. Nobody ever talks to Donnie but Walter.
I thought...
No, that's not true. That's totally not true.
Well, this is what Snyder told me, so... I'm just repeating
something. No, because at some point Donnie says, phone's ringing, dude, and
he says, thank you, Donnie.
Yeah. He totally responds.
No, Walter says thank you, Donnie.
No.
Really?
Dude says thank you, Donnie? Because the dude is walking down the street with the phone, and Donnie...
Well, I'm going to go tell Dave Snyder he's wrong right now.
That is a very popular theory right now to apply to a lot of movies, the Fight Club theory.
Well, I thought that Ferris Bueller trailer was pretty good, though.
Yeah, that's not
that
bad.
That was good.
But still, it's like after that, it's like, well, what else could we do that to?
Yeah.
I'm going to play as Walter.
But the old guy with the mustache is God, right?
Sure.
The sarsaparilla guy.
Sure.
Or he
could just be that guy hanging out in that bar.
With a bowling alley.
Yeah.
I shouldn't read too much into these things, is what you're saying.
Yeah, probably.
It's just sometimes a movie is just a movie.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait. What was I going to look for?
Light cycles. Just search for Tron in the cart section.
I feel like a keyboard would make this much faster.
Then I would have to have a keyboard in my living room.
Always Be Clothing asks, sure. What's your favorite Jeff Bridges movie?
And what I said, some sort of savage.
My favorite Jeff Bridges movie?
Seabiscuit? Be honest.
Seabiscuit.
Heartwarming story. Friends.
I mean, I guess I would have to say The Big Lebowski.
It's hard to beat The Big Lebowski.
Yeah.
Tron cars are poor.
Well, you know, they all kind of have to be cars. You can't.
I know.
You're a well-known Tron hater, Ryan. I mean...
I'm sorry that I hold them to a high standard of not being boring and bad. I know. What a son of a bitch am I.
Why do you hate everything that I love?
Because everything you love sucks.
That's just not even Tron.
Yeah, I know, but at least it looks okay.
It's pointy. It looks like it shoots fire out the back. That's pretty
Tron
cool.
Car.
I'm not going to download any of these Tron.
Yeah.
What about the Apple Dumpling Gang car?
Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. Herbie.
Can you get the bed knobs and broomstick bed? Herbie would be good.
What about Kirby?
There's no place for Kirby in a cart game. That's madness. He doesn't have arms.
He's a cart.
Oh, okay.
That could be kind of cool.
Ride around inside Kirby.
I think I might be more excited about that Kirby game than anything else coming out this Christmas.
It looked good.
It looked pretty awesome.
It looked good.
Yeah, that seemed very
cool.
That
was, I think, of the stuff that they
You played have. A little bit of it, didn't you?
I did. I played like three levels of it. It was fun. It had a nice feel to it. The whole kind of aesthetic conceit definitely
the yarn is what
like
you're talking
goes
about.
All the way through. Like they they are complete with that.
Well, it seemed like a good fit for the for the for the character, for the brand.
All right, folks, jump in. Do some invites while I'm at it.
Man with mustache.
Such as man with mustache.
Oh, man, I don't know if we want to have clowns in here. That's
already full. Already
full.
Wow.
Bad sign.
Okay.
Some of these games are familiar.
Superfly. Kessler back here. You can't go get us beers now.
I can go get beers.
You need beers? You're wearing a microphone now.
I can take the microphone off.
What?
I can get beers.
Drew can get beers.
Drew, you gonna get beers?
I can get beers. We want beers.
Drew's the greatest American hero who's ever lived.
It's true. I'll take one of the cans, please.
Do you think there's an Anthony Edwards in this game?
What?
I'm just looking at the Revenge of the Nerds poster.
Oh, like, you mean like ER era Anthony Edwards, or?
I mean Goose. I play as Goose.
Goose.
Drew took off in the direction of the bar, but I think they're sitting on that.
Yeah, they're right
Joey's
there. They're
like,
I could probably reach them with the microphone table
chance
on.
Of an actual Goose being in this game than Goose from Top Gun.
What about Geese Howard?
Be pretty good.
That would be awesome.
It's a ton of SNK characters in here.
I could totally see a Geese Howard being in here.
You really want to? This is a serious load screen.
Yeah, they said that they were working on it.
I like that it hangs at 85% for like 8 minutes. That's kind of a.
I still think it is better.
The mark of a good load screen.
They
said,
maybe they did patch it already. I don't know.
Oh yeah.
And the mark of a good load thing is that it doesn't actually progress, even though it still spins or moves or whatever.
I feel like you're being facetious.
I am being facetious, Ryan Davis.
They should have gone to Namco and asked if they could license the Let's Play a Game during the loading screen technology.
Look at that guy. He's all shiny.
That is some crazy shine. Looks like he has a skybox on his head. I thought you were playing as Walter.
I am.
That looks like Skeletor, dude.
It looks like Skeletor.
Maybe Walter and Skeletor are the same dude.
No, dude is a different dude.
Oh, okay. Good to know.
No, that's my current theory, is that Walter Sobchak's actually Skeletor.
No, that makes sense.
That I'm willing to listen to.
Yeah, let's talk about this for
There's
a minute.
Fallout Boy.
Where does She-Ra fit into this?
Anywhere she wants.
Boom. Oh.
Underwater, dude.
Oh, no.
Skeletor can't drown. He's a skeleton.
Maybe that's how he became a skeleton in the first place. He went swimming right after he ate.
That'll do it.
Yeah. Holding on strong to 10th place here.
Mr. Plague is talking about Zardoz. He wants a mod based on Sean Connery.
You know, I bet there's a lot of Sean Connery mods in this, but probably no Zardoz mods, sadly.
What was the boom?
Drive around in the big head.
That would be awesome, yeah.
Or how about just Olmec from Legends of the Hidden Temple?
Yeah.
I would drive around as Olmec.
Big stone head?
Yeah.
Oh,
no.
And then, ah!
Oh, lightning bolt followed by Smushy!
And that steals your, What is that? Why does it keep getting dark? What is that?
Well, Olmec is angry.
This game is squirrely.
Yeah, it seems like maybe you dialed the sensitivity down a little bit. And I'm not gonna tell you how to drive.
I'll just pull up the console. Also have to bind look to mouse.
Shoddy Robot has a big picture question. What other genres do you think could work with this type of user-created format? The idea of being a little big plant does platformers, Mod Nation Racers, does kart racers.
You mean the copyright infringement platform?
Yeah, Which other genres can serve as a notable platform for infringing on copyright?
Well, first-person shooters, I think, are the most well-proven genre for this.
You mean all the way back in the Doom days with the aliens?
Yeah, but those tools were never really user-friendly in the way that these were.
And it's these tools are still not user-friendly.
I would say that they didn't stop folks.
Well, user-friendlier.
Right.
Anyone else want to give this a go?
Yeah, I'll do a little racing.
Do a little racing here.
How do I not be Skeletor?
You'll have to hit R1 when we get back to the main menu thing.
I can't do that.
Then you have to play a Skeletor.
Ugh. In a mail truck. M-A-I-L.
No.
To be clear.
Okay, great.
Much to Will's chagrin.
I just wondered what a M-A-L-E truck would look like. I was curious, I'll admit.
I think they would not allow that truck.
You think it'd be offensive in some way?
I think it would be a cock, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's not dance around it. Let's not dance around
veiny
that,
and
that
throbbing, or like, you know, kind of, is there, are we going too far
here? Sort of animation like that. I don't think they, they've gotten that sophisticated.
Interesting. Seems to be an open space.
Switching into the Mach 5.
Oh, there we go.
And who drives the Mach 5? John Goodman drives the Mach 5.
Well, he was in Speed Racer.
That's right.
Yeah,
he played Pops.
Exactly. So,
right.
He played Pops Racer.
Breaking out of his comfort zone.
And
Well, how do you feel about the Speed Racer film?
You know, I love to watch it, but I hate the movie.
I think it's amazing.
I think it's graphic. I think visually it is glorious, but it is a terrible, terrible movie.
Sure.
Yeah. Definitely. But how do I change tracks and stuff?
Race settings. And then race settings again.
And then edit settings. Got it.
And yeah.
Turns out race settings isn't about ethnicity.
Yeah. Like darken up this Walter Sobchak a little bit.
I've got horrifying news, everyone. Hugh Boner says he's found the entire Giant Bomb cast as mods for this game.
Huh.
It's too late.
We're gonna try Tiku Tiku Mountain,
the 8-second track.
But then maybe that's cheating stuff, you know? Maybe that's.
What if you just back over the finish line? You go the wrong way.
Oh yeah.
You know, I love it when a game
like doesn't check for that stuff. Yeah.
For going the wrong way.
We got a Yosemite Sam. We have the Serpentor over there. Harley Quinn. Is that Squall Leonhart there with the face scar? Or
yes.
Is that a...
could be a Harry Potter.
Or that could be a Harry Potter.
No glasses, though.
Yeah. I'm going to go with my...
I think it's a Pip-Boy there, too.
First, yeah, it's definitely...
So it's triggers for gas and brake. Is X to shoot?
X to...
Jump and drift?
Skin.
No, X to drift.
Okay.
Square to power up.
Got it. Okay.
Up, up, down, down. Left, right. Left, right.
Did you know you can use the left stick to control your kart, Jeff?
Oh, left
stick. That's what I've been doing wrong the whole time.
Ah!
That's why I keep coming in last, Will. I wasn't using the correct
It's not
stick.
A tilt game, it turns out.
Oh.
You use the sticks.
I mean, really, it's pretty impressive that I got as far as I did, not knowing that the left stick.
Serpentor and that Cobra vehicle is pretty sweet.
He just scared the hell out of me. I'm a little uncomfortable now, I'll be honest.
Wow.
Whoa.
So can we talk about the time, you know, like when you hold the gas to take off? Is there?
It's different in this game.
Right.
They made it different from the typical kind of Mario Kart.
Because the Mario Kart, you hit it right between 1 and 2,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. So this one, I think it's even different. Like every time you start up.
Interesting.
So they kind of.
So they make it completely unpredictable and wild.
This TV is dark. Is this TV dark?
I can't tell if it's the TV or the game because sometimes it looks fine, and sometimes it'll just darken. I don't know.
Seems dim.
Like now it seems fine.
Well, it's because you have green fire coming out of your car ass. Did you shoot them in the finger behind you? Is that what happened?
I might have. I don't.
Got all glitchy there.
Game has drafting and drifting.
Drift.
Right.
Drafting or drifting.
I have to actually manually hit.
You drafting?
Drafting.
A nice draft beer.
Nothing better than a good draft.
Keep this coupon. And coupon is spelled with a K. Asks anyone know how the PSP version of this is?
Probably.
Thank you very much. There you go. How is it?
If we're going to throw them broad like that, I don't think anyone here knows. Will, do you have any idea?
I don't really have a PSP.
We did a quick look at that, didn't we?
Movies.
I want to say we have video of that up on the side somewhere.
I wasn't aware that a PSP version of this game existed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Does it suffer from the same awesome load times?
Probably not. I don't know.
Seems like loading from UMD would be speedier.
Oh, but you install it to the... Your
Flash?
Flash stick.
You seem to be going very fast, Jeff, but you're still in 10th place.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm kind of baffled by the crazy load times. Like, what is it loading?
Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's that much here.
Like, it doesn't seem bad, but it doesn't seem like such an exceptional amount of content. It's like, whoa.
There went the finger again, dude. You need to dial that back. This is a family-friendly
game.
Every
time you pass someone, you throw up a little something.
You know, I think
something.
He's only got four things, so I don't think he can actually throw up the finger.
Dude, that was clearly the middle one, whichever of the four it was.
But no, because if he has only four, there is no middle.
It's intent, not actual mechanics.
Maybe that's number one.
That was not a friendly gesture.
Maybe it's this. Maybe it's, ha-ha!
That's possible.
I can be unfriendly with my index finger, Will Smith. You want to see?
No, I'd rather not. I'm going to leave the room now, I think.
I
the only person that's allowed to be that unfriendly with her index finger is Mrs. Smith. Thank you very much. And I'm not even talking about my wife. I'm just talking about Angelina Jolie.
Oh, I got it. I was going to say, I believe she likes to go by Ms. Pinkett Smith.
I'm not that Will Smith. Yeah, I know. Kind of a letdown, I know.
I thought that track was not so great. No, it's not an official track.
You think it was great? That was all right. I guess the whole...
I got no beef.
A lot of it was just kind of straight, you know?
Sure.
A lot of it was just like, boost, 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 boost.
I like the part with the wicker road.
But I mean, it's pretty crazy impressive that that was all user-created right there.
Yeah.
Yes.
That whole track is, like, there's a lot of verticality to it, a lot of alternate routes.
It's like there's an infinite amount of content with these games. Lots of it's not very good.
Sure, but there's a lot of it.
But there's a lot of it.
Yeah, like the hard part becomes like this is trying to find the stuff that is good.
This is like the hometown buffet of kart racing games.
I just think back to when I was playing Super Mario Brothers 3. If I could have loaded up, you know, stuff that other people around the world created, I would have gotten more than 2 or 3 weeks worth of play out of that.
Certainly.
Mod Circuit.
Bulletproof Monk asks, do you guys like Crash Team Racing?
Yes. I am a fan of the original Crash Team Racing.
I really liked it when it came out. I thought it was a very good game.
That's probably the kart racing game that I've spent the most amount of time with.
But I couldn't imagine going back to it now.
Yeah, I don't know. If I could, it'd probably just be largely because of nostalgia for it. But I played the hell. Ah, Kuma's in the house!
Was that the Crash Bandicoot one?
Yeah. Is that a Baraka over there on the upper right?
Upper right? Oh, like the second one down?
Yeah.
Oh. Looks like it.
Might be a Jedi.
Or could be a, what's his name from God of War?
Kratos.
Kratos.
Yeah, does it look like, maybe.
No, he has space tattoos.
With the teeth.
Oh,
the guy with crazy teeth.
He's just, you know.
He was like,
he just went to the dentist and wants to show off.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Not Kratos, it's very flat, straight teeth.
Saying he's had work done?
Absolutely. Those are veneers.
Mm.
Caps? Veneers? Yeah. Makes sense.
It's an expensive mouth.
Especially in ancient Greece.
All right.
Somebody's backing up.
Let's do this.
I like that people work on their carts until right before the game starts. It really sells the illusion of race for me. Nicely done.
Now that's the end. That's the pointer finger.
Uh huh. You see what you want to see, Davis. I'll see what I want to see.
Apparently, what you want to see is silk.
Damn right.
Lots
We're on the internet. That's all there should be here.
James0890 has a question for Will.
Hello, sir.
And Will can't answer it.
I can answer.
All right, fine. He wants to know, why'd you stop playing TF2? You and James had a good soldier medic thing going.
We did have an awesome soldier medic thing going, but I heard D&D was on. I wanted to come in here, you know, see what was going on. I've never played Mod Nation before, so
All right.
I got it.
Yeah. Well, James took offense. He didn't know.
Hey, I'll be back on later. Those headphones won't test themselves.
Oh, wouldn't it be great if they would, though?
My job would be a lot easier.
Yeah.
But like, they came from straight out of the box with a label that said this gets a 2 and this gets a 7.
I'm sure that they would be happy to provide you with those numbers.
Well, it's possible.
It's a 10. It's the greatest headphone ever created.
Hey, we
only
that's
goes
what
up
we call
to 5.
Tested home of the 10. Except for we don't really give numbers to anything.
Why don't we just make a subdomain, just like 10.tested.com, and on that subdomain, all products receive 10.
Yes. That seems like it wouldn't provide a whole lot of value. That's the best finish so far tonight.
Yeah.
Depends on who you're providing value for.
I like to provide value for the readers.
Well, that's what the rest of the site is for. They should not go to 10.tested.com.
So you're saying I just set that up. When PR people ask me how their products did, I send them there, and they're like,
yeah.
Ted, woo! And then throw down the horns.
Exactly.
Seems like a bad idea. I mean, I'm never one to say that anything is a bad idea, but...
Dave, what do you think of my idea?
Sure.
All right.
Sounds like some more stupid bill. I'm all about it.
Dave, how you doing? Were you back there playing Jam?
We were playing Jam. In fact, we had Hansa Kral, our new engineer from Czechoslovakia.
Yes, the first Czech Republic.
Time, first time ever playing NBA Jam.
Uh huh.
Wow.
How did he do?
We lost by a point.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
Which I think says more about the other team than us.
Maybe.
Do they have a full contingent of fingers and hands?
No, what it was that Patrick Ewing has a flat top still in that game. I think is what put us over the edge.
That'll do it.
That's you know, the winning advantage for sure.
He actually made a jump shot for once. It was, it was a good moment.
Wow.
That's impossible.
I have a question here from username AdamBoys, who would like to know, would a Johnny V versus Capcom be the greatest fighting / rap battle game of all time?
You gotta get better questions, Kessler.
Yeah,
these are not really answerable questions.
I wish I had something to throw at you.
These are more just you saying, repeating things that are being said in the chat.
Well, tell that to AdamBoys.
Johnny V versus Capcom is a game that I would play.
You know, for a long time, the Johnny V page on Giant Bomb was what the thumbnail on Chrome was for me when I opened up the new tab.
Jesus Christ, are we in an elevator?
Yeah.
Yeah, this game's got some load times, Dave.
It's a little loady.
We've already talked about this a lot, kind of.
It's okay.
Okay.
It's still relevant.
Dave, do you need a microphone?
He doesn't have one.
Send a note to Andy to make this game load faster.
Okay. Hey, Andy, game's loading slow.
Is game loading slow for you guys?
We should put an SSD in.
And then like 5 minutes later, it's just, nope, works fine back here. You guys are all crazy. And I say, Jesus!
I actually got one of those bug reports this past weekend from Ryan. He was wearing his robe.
So you can tell that it was a legit bug report then.
But it was totally my fault. It was totally my internet connection.
It was your robe's fault?
No, the robe was not at fault. What was that, Saturday?
Terry cloth or
Saturday
flannel?
Morning. A Terry. Terry bathrobe. You know, I like to lounge.
No, Terry's the way to go.
Oh. Was there something like erotic about my Terry cloth robe?
You know what?
Was there something erotic?
Well, what's red?
No, it's blue.
Did you do a video call to let him know that there was a bug report? Or?
He was at my house.
I got a Dave.
My internet's shitty or the site's slow.
Well, everything had been going peachy up until that moment, and I guess it was just that I tried to load Giant Bomb at the same time that my internet started going crappy.
Are you still on the Comcast?
I'm still on the Comcast. They cannot stop me.
They haven't kicked you off yet?
They've not yet kicked me off, miraculously.
Wow.
I have a microphone now.
Dave's got a mic.
It makes me louder.
It does.
The internet.
It amplifies your voice.
Belligerent.
Dave, what do you think of this game?
I don't know.
Oh,
it's a poorly placed ramp.
That is bullshit. It is a kart racer.
Probably my least favorite genre.
Of least favorite of all? Wow. Really?
All genres.
So like Railroad Simulator is better than part.
Don't say shit about railroads.
You know, I'd probably.
That's a game. That's a simulator.
Light gun games.
Light gun games I think are better. They're great.
Oh, House of the Dead?
I played Lethal Enforcer. Had a good time. Play some T2.
Typing of the Dead? That's not really a light gun game.
No. And it's awesome. Yeah. I would rather... Let's turn this off and let's play some Typing of the Dead.
I'll do that right now. We can go to the other room. Leave them here. Just never look back.
Do a TNT of Typing of the Dead.
That tracks are fine.
That's pretty good. I thought it was all right. It was fun to watch. You know, it was... I think there's a balance of, you know, you want to add your twists and turns and some craziness, but if you get too crazy, then it's like you can't follow,
right?
Like where you're supposed to go.
You need a few good straight wins.
Yeah, you need to be able to, you know, pick up a little bit of speed.
Right.
You need a track that is at least in part kind of self-explanatory, self-evident.
It'd be nice if it was just rather than having to download the tracks and pick them, if there was just like a serve me up a track, yo.
Like a playlist.
Yeah.
Just like random shuffle.
Yeah, just find me a highly rated
track.
That's
Foundation Racers 2.
Yeah.
You want to try bringing a new crew?
Yes.
Yeah, let's dump these guys out.
And you want to try meat. Searching for more weird stuff at the creation?
Yeah, let's jump out and
go look at some more tracks.
Go look for something. Yeah, we'll grab a track or two.
Let's do that.
How do you guys feel about in-game menuing? Like, this is like a... I don't even know what this is called, but like where you're in the game engine,
world,
the hub
front
world.
End.
Yeah. Kind of Guild Wars thing is what I always associate it with.
Mm. Huh. All right.
But you can still pull up a menu at any time. So that entire interface is optional.
I did not know that.
Yeah. But it does cause that load time, so.
Yeah, like, yeah.
Just give me a menu. I take a menu. But yeah, I'd also take a mouse,
there you go.
The core audience.
I don't know that I would play a kart racer with a mouse.
I played Pod. You remember Pod?
I remember Pod.
P-O-D.
Yeah. P-O-D, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Different how about from the most create XP?
What sure, are we I don't think I looked at that list.
Most raced.
Most raced. I definitely looked at that.
Oh, you did look at that. Okay.
That's okay. Those are all downloaded. Go to the next page.
Oh, look at that big circle.
Oh, well, yeah, forget it. Those are all downloaded. Wow. We're going to do most create XP. We'll try that.
Those are all,
the same ones.
Except for that one.
Pick that big circle.
Get that one.
Big I jump wanted the big circle, too. They wouldn't do it. That's just set up for people to get trophies.
But we still can race on it.
Right.
Eh.
I want to see how...
Empire City trophy. Infamous.
Yeah. And he misspelled trophy. Why would we not play 5-in-1 trophy where he misspelled trophy? This is probably terrible. I know.
Did you spell it T-R-O-F-I-E?
No, T-R-O-P-H-I-E. Very close.
Trophy's 5-in-1.
How about Tropi?
Oh, see, that's it. It's supposed to be trophies, but you can't see the S in that screenshot. So he's...
That does make more sense.
He's okay.
Yeah. Somebody he knows what the score is.
Tell the engineers to stop cropping images.
Yeah.
Auto crop.
Oh, speaking of which, when you embed large size screenshots in news stories, the right side gets cut off.
I've been told this. You know, it doesn't happen on Will's site.
What?
So we don't... Yeah.
You should...
Just be more like me, Jeff.
God, no. You think you're good. We're going to play. We're going to get this one.
Don't apologize.
I love
the
spelling.
Don't encourage bad apostrophes.
Oh, we'll play it and we'll rate it 1 star.
Yep.
Can you rate things 0 stars?
No.
Lamac Fox has a good question. Have we seen anything obscene in the game so far?
All of this is pretty obscene to me.
But we haven't
Toy
seen...
Toy Story car. Think about it.
Buzz and Woody.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Buzz and Woody.
I don't get it.
Yeah,
I'm,
sex toys.
Oh, I still don't really get it.
Futurama space
Buzz
ship.
Like the vibrations of
too fast,
a
too furious
aid.
Skyline. All right,
you mean like a back massager?
Like a back massager.
Interesting.
Train. Ooh, get that train. Get that fucking train.
I want to drive Thomas the Tank Engine.
Get that train.
Johnny train.
Gotta get that train.
What train?
Kids love trains.
Train. Yeah. All right.
That's a sick train.
Fly ass train.
Can you put a train in the train? Can we double train?
We put Astro train in the train.
I thought we weren't supposed to talk about disgusting things.
We didn't have Optimus Prime driving Optimus Prime earlier.
I did see that, and it was, you know what? It's like a new form.
Yeah, I know.
Of
eroticism.
Yeah.
I feel like there's probably a whole Usenet group like dedicated to Prime on Prime fanfic.
I don't know how many prefixes you'd have to use to describe that action.
No FX4208, which staff member can make the boss grilled cheese sandwich?
I use three cheeses. That's all I got.
I am a very basic. I like American cheese and my grilled cheese sandwiches. And nowhere else.
Campbell's, some Campbell's tomato.
Campbell's tomato soup on the side.
How do I dry?
What are you trying to do?
I just like that in the menu, there's a Mario right there on the left. Right there.
He's the top. He's one of the top dudes, so he's in the top.
Who is it right now? It's Mario and some sort of hell demon and a walrus.
I have to say, props to Nintendo for not like cease and desisting this out of existence. Because they could.
It hasn't sold well enough.
What are you trying to do, Jeff?
Change my dude.
Go back. I think you have to do that.
It's over back up into the left.
No, R1.
Okay.
R1. There we go. I was hitting that earlier and it was not doing anything. Okay. So where's this sick ass train?
That is a sick ass train.
I don't know if anybody's ever described Thomas the Tank Engine as sick ass before.
We are right now.
We are pioneering. We are online pioneers. Onlineoneers.
Can you change your steering wheel? Is that what the third thing
is? You can change like the balance between acceleration and top speed.
Interesting.
Pioneers.
I think Monopoly Guy should be driving
the train. I think Spider-Man is way into trains.
Spider-Man.
Uncle Moneybags.
Is it Uncle Moneybags?
Uncle Spider-Man.
Uncle Spider-Man.
You know, he does whatever a spider can.
Uncle Peter Porker. All right, I'm just going to do drift donuts here in the lobby for the next
hour
15.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I'm dizzy.
Yeah. All right, race station. Let's go.
Dagger Eye asks, perfect. What happened in the elevator at California Extreme?
What? Oh, right.
The elevator story.
The elevator story. Nothing. I don't know. I don't know that it really translates.
Well, you weren't there.
I wasn't even there.
Yeah.
I don't know. Oh.
Elevator.
Oh, that elevator. Yeah.
See, us not talking about it makes it sound way more like insidious than it is. It was kind of dumb.
I'm going to go ahead and tell you I've never wanted to know anything more in my life.
There was a dude in an elevator, and he was dumb.
We're going to play Alcohol You Think You're Good.
And he was probably baked. Based on the
All right, we're going to create soon, so everybody get ready to join.
And the fact that he had 12 churros.
I think it was when he said, smoke them if you got them.
So, smoke them if you got them, as he was getting out of the elevator. And really, that's the punchline, so we're kind of done.
I guess we just must look like stoners or something?
I don't know.
You did have your Chemistry Now shirt on.
I did. Chemistry Now is a better t-shirt.
We were wearing sunglasses.
Chemistry Powered, I believe.
Well, Jack Frost.
2 o'clock in the morning?
No, it's middle of the day.
One.
Yeah.
I like that there's a giant bomb over there on the right.
Yep. Yeah.
WR311, we're suing you. Keep that in mind.
There's your Daft Punk robot on the left. Boom.
And Mr. Fucking Peanut.
Yeah. Oh, dude.
I
need to get myself a copy of this game.
Just for copyright purposes.
I was gonna say that's Jack Frost there, right below Spider-Man.
I mean, that's why I went out and bought it, because I wanted to see all the stuff people were putting together.
Yeah.
But I'm not necessarily having a great time playing it. I love seeing the stuff.
And that is a really
the fact that you had to ask what the controls were.
What's kind of crazy is it doesn't.
I went and bought it and then didn't play it for like a week because I didn't have time, and then played it for like half an hour, but most of that time was spent looking at a loading screen, so I was like, okay, I'm good.
Have you still been playing Blur?
Heck no.
See? That is why I just don't think the genre works very well, unless you're like sitting around.
It has to be people on the couch. People.
Yeah.
Like, we should have four people sitting on the couch. Fuck the internet.
We've got three people. If you'd like to come sit next to us.
I'm not squeezing in. No, I'm comfortable.
Well, I mean, that's why people want to crack this code.
I'm a big boy.
So
we can pretend like we're in a cab on our way to, you know.
I've got no feeling in this knee, so you would.
Keep it going.
Come on.
No, it's okay. It's okay. We're good. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just because the beer's here.
Four people on the couch.
I don't think my cord's long enough, actually.
Oh. There you go. Here
we go.
Four people. We don't have four controllers, though.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Let's sit way forward. This is
four
increasing.
Four people.
Get in there.
Oh, there we go. We got four.
You just got to work it.
Do we have an awesome HR department yet?
Thanks, man.
Yeah, it's Melissa.
She's in the bar getting loaded playing NBA jams.
HR's drunk.
I haven't had enough beer for this.
Kind of like Spider-Man.
So
Drunk Spider-Man should not be allowed to conduct a train.
Spiaita.
I think my point about the four people on the couch was that we should all be playing against each other.
Oh.
Yeah.
I like split screen.
I like the four people on the couch part.
It's a nice big couch. It's roomy.
It's actually it's pretty good.
Kind of got a little velour thing.
Four not small dudes on this couch. A testament to the size of this couch.
I've got the forward shoulders though. Which I don't want to encroach on Jeffy.
He's trying to play over here. He's,
serious business is happening here.
I could scooch further down this way. There we go.
Keep on doing it. Since you all got on the couch, we have way more people watching the stream.
Great.
Do you remember Spider-Man?
I do remember Spider-Man. That's still my username on Comic Vine.
You know, it's really sad when somebody names themselves on a site after a one-off joke on a podcast or a website.
No. I named myself Spider-Man because I was at a flea market years and years and years ago when I saw bootleg Spider-Man toys called Spader-Man.
Yeah.
So it was just James Spader.
So when I went to create my account on Comic Vine, many years ago, I thought, what would be my superhero name? The
Spider-Man.
Non-copyright infringing Spider-Man.
But, so here's the funny part. He was maybe like username, I think, 25 on Comic Vine. And then so the week after that, we actually get a write-up on TechCrunch. And like they start talking about the site and they talk about all the crazy users on Comic Vine. And who do they fucking broadcast?
Did they really say that?
It's still, you can go look it up.
I had no idea.
Spider-Man. And they pull out like Ryan's one-liner of, you know, the guy who steals every copyright infringement possible.
Yeah, nice. it's very tongue-in-cheek character. Yes.
You know, I feel like
I'm glad someone saw that. I spent some time writing that stuff up. I thought it was kind of funny.
A lot of people saw it, right? You were internet famous for a little while there.
Fleeting moments of internet fame. Yeah.
Not anymore.
Take them if I can get them.
And where did it get you?
On a couch with three other dudes.
Yeah, lots of body heat.
Watching this car.
It's a little sweaty, actually. Good thing we're sitting on velour.
Oh, hose this room down when we're done.
Oh, wall.
This is that thing right there is poorly placed.
You keep running into that that little pylon, little archway.
I like the mashers, but I feel like they should always put a speed thing under the masher to kind of taunt you.
Entice you.
Right.
Like, oh. I mean,
you should want to go under there.
Like, oh, you're going to go under there.
Oh, shit. Well.
Someone send us the TechCrunch article.
Great.
Users can create their own superhero as well. This guy, for example, has called himself Spider-Man.
Great. That's me.
Congratulations.
That's me, TechCrunch.
Spider-Man. Ryan was available.
Do your research.
But you went with
this guy.
Spider-Man.
You know what the funny part is?
Spider-Man is the funny part.
No, it's that like most sites will try and rig like users.
Yeah.
And here we were with your fake user that got picked anyway.
Yep.
What's Spider-Man's superpower, Ryan? That's the question.
What's that? His ability to...
he's always serious.
His ability to circumvent copyright law.
And he never wears pants. It also, you know, Spader movies.
Here's a question for Jeff.
Oh, wow.
What's the question for Jeff?
Jeff wants to be asked this question.
Good save.
Can someone...
That was clean.
Can someone start screening Kessler's questions?
I know. We need like another layer between us and Kessler here. Kessler asks it, and then someone like reforms it into an actual question.
Matt Bodega does.
Feeds it to us, yeah.
Matt Bodega screams.
Hey, I have a question. Pie is awesome.
not really a question.
Yes, no.
Totris wants to know, hey, Jeff. Next week, the Borderlands DLC is $5 each on Xbox Live Arcade. Is Mad Moxie worth $5?
If you really like Borderlands.
No, it's not.
If people play with you.
Mad Moxie's terrible.
Good answer, Jeff.
Mad Moxie's terrible.
Yeah, if you have people that'll play with you and you kind of don't care if it's not good, then it's great.
The other ones are good.
Yeah, the other
General
ones are good.
The one is awesome.
The other ones are genuinely good. Mad Moxie's...
If you really like Borderlands and don't care that part of it will kind of suck, then you should get it.
If you are willing to pay $5 for something that kind of sucks.
Well, it's for completionists.
Yeah.
Sure, okay. All right.
Are there achievements in those too?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and they're a bitch to get.
They are brutal. They are effing.
Yeah, you have to play like 300 rounds or
they
something
are
ridiculous, right?
Fucking brutal.
Yeah.
You know, when you say effing and then follow it up with fucking, it really
removes the impact. Do the loopy track.
Oh, we're going to try Empire City, straight out of Infamous.
Oh, boom.
Maybe we should just slow down the speed class.
I like it.
Let's crank go
it
right
up.
Drop it down
go
to pro.
Go all the way to the top.
We've been doing Elite for a while.
Oh, have we been doing Elite?
Yeah.
Let's take Rookie.
I want to see what Rookie is.
What's his
full drop? We've done no races in Rookie so far.
This turns off power-ups.
Oh, so it becomes not a kart racer at that point.
Yeah.
Keep action race.
Can you add more players and make some of them AI? Can you have like 36 players and 12 real people and 24 AI?
No. You can have, you know, 4 real players and fill the rest with AI. But
Pachango is now without the face hugger.
You can totally. There's like 8 player AI on, AI off options.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So you can have like just 8 players and just 8 real people. Or
right.
Guys, I've got news that's kind of a bummer.
What's
Vorbis
up?
Reminds us, fun tip. That Empire City map was made by the Sucker Punch developers.
Great.
So they're game designers.
Great. So hopefully it'll be a good track for once.
It's only got 3.5 stars.
Double tap the X button to super hop over hazards, Jeff.
I didn't know you could do that.
You can't.
I'm trying to hop over the load time.
Again?
It is hazardous.
Why does nobody show, you know, if they knew the load times were, why don't they show 2 tips? Per load screen.
Because they would have to load up the tip and it would take longer.
Yeah, then it would be a longer load time.
Do you think loading a JPEG really adds that much?
Absolutely.
Okay.
You know, I wouldn't think that loading up a kart racing map would take this long.
It's true.
But low. That guy's driving
it's a actually because there's a dude with a tape that has to jam it into
is
the
thing. Is that supposed to
it looks
be
like
a
King
guy?
Of the Hill character.
I was going to say, I kind of got that vibe myself. Spider-Man's all shiny.
He looks like he has scales.
Just like the real Spider-Man.
Yeah, just
like spiders.
Yeah.
Man, that's a great start to a map.
Right on a ramp. Oh my god. This totally feels like Empire City.
It's all desaturated.
I feel like there should be more lightning. Whoa.
Dexter Slew asks, yo Will, when's the next Tested podcast?
Yo, Dexter, as soon as I edit the one that's sitting on my hard drive right
Boom.
Now.
Boom.
So not, tonight?
Not in the next 40 minutes.
Midnight, Thursday night, just like every week.
Mike was bringing guests by the office today.
Yeah.
And I love how they always describe your guys' podcast room as, and there is our soundproof podcast room.
It's not really soundproof, though.
It's not soundproof
at all. And the engineers, of course, will always say, unless Will, Jeff, or Ryan is in it.
Yeah, I came back to my desk today because I was sitting there by myself recording a podcast with a special mystery guest over Skype.
Whoa.
And
who was it?
Special mystery guest.
Come on, you tell us.
Yeah. Okay.
We won't tell nobody. Here.
His name starts with.
Is it Gary Whitta again?
Gary Busey.
So at a certain point, that stops being like, special or mysterious.
No. Maybe Gary will be back next week. But we have a guest from another country today. That's all I'm going to say.
Roman Polanski.
Damn it.
Ah, nailed it!
Damn it!
You know, I know who it is, and you know why?
Because you sit next to the
podcast. You see everything that comes out of that crystal podcast.
Well, it might be that glass door that they mounted on it. That might be keeping the soundproofing from really, you know.
I'll give you a clue. He's Canadian.
What?
Yes.
Bob and Doug McKenzie.
It is not Bob and Doug McKenzie. They're also fictional characters.
Joe Flaherty.
No, it's not really anybody. It's a special guest, but not like a very special guest.
John Candy.
It's actually Mike Myers. See, I told you, nobody's excited about Mike Myers.
He's coming out with his new line of computer accessories.
Well,
so I purchased a mouse pad.
Yes. Yes.
No, it's just a bunch of filters for all the text-to-speech stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Comes out in British accents.
Basically, I just sat in there and talked for an hour by myself about stuff. A pretty long bit about socks.
Like tech socks?
No, just socks.
It's a great plug.
Yeah.
Tell me about your socks.
You guys want to be online at midnight to download that right when it hits the internet.
We did talk about socks recently.
Really?
You and I.
About Ethan's socks?
Hmm?
Did we talk about Ethan's socks?
We were talking about those crazy synthetic socks.
Oh, the smart wools.
Smart
wool
socks.
They're not synthetic. They're smart wool. They're wool.
Ah.
But smart.
We'll make some
is it
smart wool.
Synthetic? aesthetics that make them
I think they're called Smart Wheel because they're for smart. Like Ryan and me.
They can display E-ink on it.
Ooh.
That would be pretty rad.
I ain't got no smart socks.
Best finish yet. 7th place. Unofficial result. No.
The Spider-Man train keeps on chugging.
I would say the face, the Thomas face on this is poor, but I like the rest of the
train.
The joy that Thomas.
I thought that was a fine track.
Yeah, that was fine.
That was a four-star. Good big jumps. That was a four-star track.
You played a five-star track yet?
No.
No.
What's a five-star track like?
Crapneck says what
Princess's Peach's Castle.
Yeah.
Why are you shaking your chin at me? You want me to play?
Yeah, you want to play some?
I'll play some.
All right.
Oh man. X is drift.
Yep.
Stick or pad?
Stick.
And square is
To fire. Yep. L1 is turbo.
Good to know.
When you build up your boost by drifting.
Okay.
Or you can use that energy as a shield by hitting circle.
Interesting.
And then, R2, L2.
R2 for
gas.
We've already established that I don't really use the brakes.
First hit X.
And then hit X again.
To change track.
Can we do the spiral?
Hold on a second here, Matt.
Where should we go?
Let's get set up.
Let's
try Monte Carlo.
Where's Monte Carlo?
I like Kessler's Paul Schaefer microphone that you guys have set up for him. It's like kind of dropping from the sky.
He said he wanted to sing.
I'm ready for like a keyboard jam.
We're not really seeing
him. He is endearing himself in a Paul Schaefer-like manner so far.
We need to shave his head if he wants to be Paul Schaefer.
Oh, God. You're not wrong about my desire to shave Matt Kessler's head.
Whoa. This is the worst.
That's a bad idea.
Oh, but he needs it. He's been promising a haircut for a while now.
You can't shave it if it's hiding.
That's a bad way to go back to college. What happened to you? Oh, I got a job.
Doctors, Remy, lawyers.
I'm playing as Inspector Gadget, driving the General Lee.
But you hated gadgets.
I do hate gadgets.
So I
press start to start the race.
Yeah.
I like Inspector Gadget, though. I just hate the word gadget. Mm.
Do you like his gadgets?
I do. Because they go.
Do you think Inspector Gadget respects his technology?
I like that you put your hood on to protect your hair.
As though I was suddenly going to just... A razor was going to manifest in my hands.
What about Gidget?
Gidget's okay.
Yeah.
It's kind of cute. Sound of feel back then. Like the 40s. She was hot. Cute. Yeah. Had the funny... The wimple.
Yeah.
Wimple.
Yeah. Oh, no, that was the Flying Nun.
Yeah.
Yeah, same thing. Same girl, though.
Sally Field?
I feel like we should be at more than 5% by now.
Was she the Flying Nun?
She was the Flying Nun.
She was the Flying Nun.
Yeah.
And Gidget. Within weeks of each other.
She wasn't Gidget.
Who was Gidget?
Someone else was Gidget.
Really?
Pretty sure.
I don't know any of this stuff.
Burt Reynolds was Gidget.
Burt Reynolds was Gidget.
Burt Reynolds was the guy who drove the 18-wheeler in Smokey and the Bandit.
I heard there...
No, he wasn't. He was the Bandit.
Ernie Wopat was the Bandit.
You're just making shit up.
Yeah.
Christopher Christofferson.
Now you're thinking of Convoy.
Yes, I am.
I know.
Always.
All times.
Best song. Best song from a movie in the 70s.
Best rap song.
Yes.
R&B.
Yeah.
New age.
I've forgotten everything about the control. Hey, so what's the boost takeoff secret here?
Start revving up as soon as you hit the gas. So you want to hit the gas after one, but before launch.
I like that we've got Stormtrooper versus Inspector Gadget versus Samus versus Master Chief.
So hit it about here? Yeah.
I'm a little late.
Yeah, that was a little early probably.
Okay.
It's okay.
Nobody's judging?
The beginnings are so chaotic anyways.
Yeah, if you rev up too much, then...
Holy Jesus.
A little squirrely.
Yeah, this is... Whoa, Wall. I'm getting my just desserts for all the snide remarks I made about Wall hitting earlier. Took my ball. Yes, Bodega?
What's up?
You looked like you had a question.
I had a question for you.
Okay.
But I didn't know how hard you needed to concentrate on this video for.
I don't think it's going to help much, so fire away.
It's a lost cause already, so just go ahead. Throw it out there.
Not Rage wants to know, is Gadget the equivalent of gamer?
Is that a horrible term?
I don't know how much you guys know about my feeling about the word gadget, but...
I know, you hate it.
I don't hate it, but I mean, I just feel like it's a diminutive term that people who don't understand technology apply to something I feel strongly about as a revolutionary force that's changing the world in a positive way.
What about gizmos?
Gizmos? Well, see, that's...
How about...
Don't put water on them.
Yeah. How about
yes.
Yes,
gee-gaw. Gee-gaw is much better. I feel like I'm going very slowly.
Are you okay with buttons?
Buttons are cool.
What about flashing buttons?
Flashing buttons are also okay. Do you like fish sticks?
Oh, God.
Kessler?
I do like fish sticks. Good to know. I haven't had one in a while, though.
Oh, I have boost.
You got all the boosts.
I'm pressing my right...
L1.
L1. Oh, this is good to know.
The L stands for left.
Thank you, Kessler.
These are important tips. It's true. I can use that.
This is pro level.
I mean, I'll say this for Kessler.
Accurate. Accuracy above all.
It's for left.
There's where you replace the tips. You just get like a little video. Yeah. Like, you know, just the L stands for left.
Thanks, Kessler.
Oh, shit. Green fire. Oh, my God. I'm going so fast. I can see through time.
Going fast yet not fast enough.
I feel like I'm you know.
You're giving these guys
moving up into eighth place here.
You coming up into eighth.
I just shot somebody the bird as Inspector Gadget, so I got that going for me.
Take that penny and or brain.
You know what? Oh, my God. Oh, no.
Where the hell are those slackers?
I can't operate under these conditions. You know what? We need Pinky and the brain.
I imagine those have to be on here somewhere.
You think? I think those would be kind of tough to pull off. Oh. The brain would be easier than Pinky.
Pinky's a little skinny for this kind of game.
But yo.
The wall.
Narf.
Yes, thank you, sir. Narf indeed. Well, maybe a little Ren and Stimpy, perhaps?
Nah.
I feel like anything where you have to change the width of items in the game is going to be messed up. We couldn't find a Tron Light site. Those cars are too fat.
Yeah, all the cars kind of have to be the same.
Wide.
Wow, wall. Keeps giving me the
level
supercharger.
Level 2 supercharger.
I know,
yeah, there you go.
Right into the curves.
Perfect.
Awesome.
Perfect. Yes.
Perfect time to use that.
Extra timing. Wall.
Wow, wall. You're really enjoying this, aren't you, Ryan?
No, it's okay. I mean, I knew it would happen. That's why I wasn't sweating it when I was playing.
Well, that's the way it always works. It's hard to talk and play.
It is hard to talk and play, and this game has a fairly
not last, baby.
Handling model. Good
not
for you.
Last.
Well, did.
You got pavement?
Give somebody else the...
That's some
guy's in a giant bomb car.
I like that.
Driving as a U.
That guy's got a face hugger on
him. Face hugger, yes.
There's Master Chief in the Toy Story car.
That's not really part of the continuity, but what do we think of this track? Two?
That seemed all right. I kind of liked it.
I'll give it
You know, it's your...
I'm going to say three, because I lost.
It's okay.
It's okay. Continuing.
All right, we should probably dump these dudes and get
I'm going to hand that off to you then, sir.
Okay,
I'm not exactly sure how to do that.
Get a new posse up in here. What time is it?
Oh, it's about 5:30.
Wow. Time just flies.
It does.
When you're having fun.
When you're racing your...
Mods.
Racing your mods off.
Mod them if you got them.
Got your custom tailored suit.
Yep.
Tricked out scooter. Listening to The Who.
Are we allowed to ask questions to the audience?
Yeah.
Can that work?
Yeah, totally.
Okay, so last night I found out that there is a Marky Mark autobiography.
Okay.
That he wrote in like 1993.
Oh, yeah. When he was still an underwear like model and rapper?
And supposedly it's dedicated to, let's say, a piece of his anatomy.
All right. Yeah.
And so this got me excited. I was like, I need to read that book because I bet that book is crazy.
Probably.
So then I went on Amazon and tried to find it.
Uh huh.
No luck. It's out. It's out of print.
Where
can I get this Marky Mark book?
Go to that bookstore on Hate Street.
What author did you search on?
On Hate Street? Yeah,
there's an awesome music.
It's Marky Mark. It's autobiography.
You can search for Mark Wahlberg?
No, I think it may be Mark Wahlberg, but I think the book's just called Marky Mark.
What's the name of the? It's just called Marky Mark. It's not like say,
like
Marky Mark and the Funky Book.
Like no.
Is anyone else thinking about Boogie Nights, or is it just me?
I didn't. I don't get the reference.
Mark Wahlberg was in Boogie Nights.
Really? Interesting.
He was Mr. Knight.
Yes. I thought that was Burt Reynolds.
Oh, that's right.
That's Tom Cruise.
In Sharky's Machine.
Day and Night.
Yeah.
And what about the kid from Almost Famous? What was he in that movie?
Patrick Fugit.
Yes.
Man, how bad is that I know that kid's name?
That's pretty bad.
That kid was perfect for that movie.
I'll say whatever. You're also a fan of Risk Cutters, so.
That's how you know that name.
What's that supposed to mean?
Just in general?
Movie
or
that he's in.
Oh, he was okay. also in.
So euphemism for anything?
Is he in Spun? I think that was the only other movie I can remember.
Spun is the movie with.
John Leguizamo.
Yeah, and what's her name? The girl who's dead. Brittany Snow. Brittany Murphy.
Catherine Hepburn?
Yes, Catherine Hepburn.
Allie McGraw.
I don't think Catherine Hepburn's dead, dude.
Oh,
yes, she is.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, she is.
She's as dead as Brittany Murphy.
Waiting on a player 12.
Dave, yes. Here you go. We found it.
Player 12.
We found where we can purchase it.
Marky Mark, paperback, new from $54.99.
See? I knew.
Used $27.54.
That has got to be worth it. If he's held that book out of print for so long.
There's the brain as requested.
Nice.
Okay, one of them is an unauthorized biography of Mark Wahlberg.
That's not what we want. Wow.
But one of them is the real deal.
If it's an unauthorized biography that he wrote, then I'm interested.
Yeah. This great picture on the cover.
Fuck you, me. I'm not going to let you publish this book. It's terrible.
He also
or it was
did
like his agent, like his representation would say, no, we can't. This can't be an official Marky Mark brand.
Well, whatever.
Product.
I'm putting it out.
He also apparently did a fitness video.
Yes, he did.
At the same time, which I have never seen.
I saw some clips of it in the latest TV Carnage compilation.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's
pretty
good.
Is he
doing steps? What's he doing?
He's like lifting weights or something.
Shirt off?
Is he hanging out in like a chain and spark factory and deadlifting dumbbells?
There's a molten metal in the background.
Is it black and white except for sparks?
That's how I remember it now, but it's been a week and a half, so who can say?
There's Jason Voorhees driving the Ghostbusters car, driving Ecto-1.
Signed copy of Marky Mark the autobiography at Ioba Books for $185.
That's probably worth it.
That could be worth it.
Well, now
that
I know.
Sit
now
next
I know.
Shaq.
I was gonna say, now I know what to get Dave for Christmas.
Yeah.
This track is a little crazy.
Seems improbable again.
Yikes!
You with your probabilities.
Well, I'm just wondering if you go
it
off
also
the edge.
Seems improbable that Apple would release a phone that has an antenna that stops working when you hold the phone.
Well, hold the phone. They
who
did
uses
what?
Their phone to make calls,
and
really,
here
Ryan?
We are. Who holds their phone in their hands?
The lesson is that hands are for chumps.
I've yet to have significant issues with my iPhone.
Camels.
Well, in fact,
you're
I got
just a
my bumper.
Apple fanboy, Jeff.
I got my bumper and then put it on and said, "This is garbage." And
yeah,
took
that bumper's
it off.
That bumper's worse than whatever possible issue.
The bumper
the
is terrible.
Thing.
It just feels cheap.
Yeah, it feels awful.
It wiggles.
It's ill-fitting.
It's like it pushes down the power button. Am I going the wrong way now? What the hell?
Where's the arrow? Everybody's going the other way.
Yeah, wrong way. Wrong way.
Oh my god!
Illegal shortcut.
We need to go back to the pull-out and tennis. That's what I want.
Like in a Motorola.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that I want. Some piece of plastic.
At least that would be an option. Like if they made it like an optional thing. Like it's normally in the phone, but if your hands are wet.
Yeah.
If you're in my house where there's no signal on any carrier, then pull out your antenna.
Yeah.
It's retractable.
Well, is it part of the deal, like the FCC prefers that you put the antenna near the bottom of the phone,
that's
not
it.
The top?
Because of all the hype about brain cancer and well, but I mean, it's one of those things that's never been like scientifically proven that there's a connection. There's like
science.
Two Swedish surveys, and you know how the Swedes are. They eat rotten fish. So
that's been known to stave off brain cancer.
That's true, but it's a long-standing problem.
They love their cell phones, which is why they have to eat all that rotten fish.
Yes, the nice thing about reviewing Apple stuff is that since the iPad came out, I've been accused of being that seems bad. I've been accused of being an app that also seems bad.
It's a bad place to start.
That was an illegal shortcut.
Yeah, this seems more app. Okay, boo. Yeah, I mean, I've been accused of being an Apple super fan with my iPad review.
Uh-huh.
And now I'm some sort of lunatic Apple hater. Turns out I just test things.
Yeah, that's how it is for video games, too.
Yeah, you guys get that. Yeah, you're no strangers.
You get it coming and going.
Why are we playing PlayStation 3 games this week?
Because we love Sony and the PlayStation 3.
Oh,
it's our favorite company and our favorite product.
I knew it!
So we were
shoving.
They gave us $1 billion to do it.
We're actually changing the name of the site from Giant Bomb to Giant PlayStation 3 next week.
No, I'm sorry, you didn't hear. Engineering's working on 10.giantbomb.com.
The new official tagline of Giant Bomb is make.believe.
Yeah.
Is it too soon to stop making fun of that?
No.
Okay, cool.
I would also like to say, if you want to see someone get defensive, go make fun of Tony's blogging.
Bloggy? You What's know, a blog?
His little, bloggy, it's like a their little flip camera. Mm. Except they call it the bloggy. Which is...
Because it's from the internet, yo.
This is like...
Yo, I'm from the internet.
Point blank, the worst name for any product I've ever heard.
Yo, I got a blog. What if I want to put video on it? Clearly, I need a bloggy. I won the bloggy in 07 for...
for your blog?
Yeah, for best new blog.
The bloggy.
That was before they'd invented the Sony bloggy. How'd you do that,
Jeff? Yeah, so he...
Well, yeah, I mean, Sony, I think, owes me some money. Again.
It was a hell of a new website. Apocalypse for Sandwich. Classic.
Ah! Hey, Jeff, that's a wall.
Walls.
Kind of a corner,
actually. How do those work?
This is a little jumpy for me, this track.
It's a structure that's perpendicular to the ground.
Whoa.
This is how walls work, dude.
Look here, Dr. Science.
I like the camels.
Yeah, I like that there's a lot of camels. Right. Someone's just like, oh, I got this camel model.
It's like Jeff Minter made this.
Let's just throw the camel everywhere.
The space camel?
Yeah.
Compensation for my brother's car.
Good job, Jeff. You want me to take over, Jeff?
Silvestre. Yeah. Why don't you just drive it?
I'll do a little drive.
Bon Bolopti asks, what's the worst mascot?
What would you give that?
Would I give that track? I don't know. Probably like a 2.
Yeah.
It works.
Sorry, Matt. I didn't mean to interrupt.
No, I didn't interrupt over the important part.
It has a workmanlike quality to it.
Yes.
Sylvester
looked confused.
Sylvestre.
Oh, Sylvestre.
Yeah, to avoid copyright infringement.
It's good.
Looney Tunes people.
It's his French brother-in-law.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh.
I wonder if he's related to the family.
Oh, hey, suffering, how do you say, socotage?
That accent just kind of fell.
What? Best French accent in the business. The best, accent business.
Best, yes. Worst accent. You know what? You call it the famous flying camel, you make good on that.
We don't have many multi-used accents in the office. We've got your Mexican gangster,
uh-huh.
I guess. There's my Russian programmer.
Right.
Ryan, he never really throws out the accent ever. None?
Yeah,
what do you got?
Yeah, no, I'll do the bad French every once in a while.
Not the good French.
This is a serious business office.
Do not let Ryan give you the bad French.
Yeah.
Is that another euphemism? Is that like the double double prime?
Yeah, it's like a double optimist, but somehow
you'll be sniffing the mustard.
A little more diseased. Shadow the Hedgehog.
Shadow the Hedgehog.
He's got guns.
That's right, y'all.
Drew's got that great Lithuanian accent that we hear all the time.
Yeah,
he's never on camera.
I guess we haven't seen the turtle truck, so
I bet it's a van.
Looks like it has a periscope.
Just download April O'Neil.
Mega Man. Oh my God, it's a tarp.
Huh?
See who that is there on the right? Nabs is playing as Admiral Akbar.
Yep. Yeah. And there's a Bowser and a Luigi and a Mega Man and
that's a good Clank.
Good looking Clank. That's probably an official, actual, like pre-made Clank though.
That's why it's so
I should kick him out.
Just
posers.
No licensed content for this game.
That's right.
What are you thinking?
Bowser looks sleepy.
I'm sleepy.
Dude's been chasing princesses and fighting stupid partners for a long time.
Kessler tip. Time for the Kessler tip.
All right. Here's today's Kessler tip.
You posted a video today, Kessler?
No, it'll go up a little later. Kessler Camp continues.
The highlight of my day, Kessler.
It's a bad acronym.
It's a bad acronym, which is why I'm going to stick with it.
Okay.
You can't argue with that.
The healing power of bad acronyms?
I don't know if there's a healing power, but there's a power.
Yes. The sinister power of bad acronyms.
Well, now you're just caging it in all this negative imagery.
Drew's so quiet back there.
Well, he's monitoring us and making sure it doesn't be.
Lithuanians are sometimes like that.
Yeah.
You need to have professionals in here.
I thought he was Dutch. The blonde hair.
I try not to think about it. We're all people, Will.
Hey, yes. Man, you're the one that's always going to the race menu.
Whoa.
You are in second place. This is the best. Oh, never mind. Sounds fading out.
Oh, God.
It's because he's so edgy.
Turbo boost. Do the red tips make you more edgy or less edgy on the?
Haven't seen much shooting. Is there shooting?
There's power ups.
Power ups.
You shoot up. But shoot out some stuff.
It seems like everybody does the boost.
We move beyond shooting here.
Can we just get beyond Thunderdome?
No.
Can you really?
Spirit Zero. Like that movie Beyond Thunderdome.
Oh my, laughing mid-question.
Perfect. I like that it took a beat. That was great.
Oh, the masher. They put the bombs under the masher. This is the perfect level.
Yeah, they got me.
It's good design right there.
That is.
Risk versus reward.
Right. Yep. That's what games are all about.
Yeah.
Where's your
down
team,
Kessler?
I like the question just completely gone.
Kessler's in church with the giggle fits.
Kessler has now missed a tip and a question.
My bad stolen joke.
Yeah.
All jokes are stolen, right?
No, knock and boost is a pretty good trophy name.
That one's very specifically stolen.
Yeah. Whole comedy's theft. Spirit Zero F says that Akbar says it's a track.
That was terrible.
So we've got another accent.
I'm like, really pumped that
7 minutes of build up for, I mean, it's not his fault that the joke didn't live up to the build up. I blame Kessler.
No, it's that the joke didn't need to be said.
No, the joke was good. The joke was fine. Yeah.
The joke,
it's a track. It's fine. Yeah.
Yes. It would be even funnier if Akbar was holding up a track.
He's racing on a track though.
Don't get too literal, Jeff.
Him holding up the track is probably the most literal. Then it's him literally saying.
You're absolutely correct. I rescind my earlier criticism.
Track.
He's got a point with his index finger.
I want to hear Kessler's
tip. What if he's secretly a heroin addict?
Well, then it's track.
Akbar? Do you think heroin even does anything to lobster calamari guys?
I don't know. Let's go pump up some fish with some smack and find out.
Oh, this is the best website.
First, we had to go down to the Tenderloin to buy some smack.
Then we went to Fisherman's Wharf.
Because after we had all that smack, it just seemed like a good idea.
Then we went to space.
We couldn't have any fish, but we got this walrus really fucked up.
I fell asleep.
We have walruses here? Sea lions.
I fell asleep standing up.
But that's okay. We had a bloggy, and it caught it all.
We had to make Dot believe it onto the internet with Taylor Swift.
President Barack Barr, who would know a thing or two, says, I can tell you on authority that heroin does not affect mon cows.
Good to
but
know.
Just heroin. So, let's get some PCP.
Yes, let's! It's the best thing you've suggested all week.
Okay, so part of that Marky Mark biography.
Yeah,
okay.
Oh my God.
Said that when he was 13 years old, he blinded some Vietnamese guy, beat up a bunch of Vietnamese guy, and that's why I ended up in whatever.
Juvie?
So, lost an eye. Dude.
He took a man's sight.
Some guy, took his eye. And now, multi-million-dollar film star.
Yeah, well, you know, you gotta learn how to handle the rough and tumble world of Hollywood. What better way than to rob someone of his sight?
Yeah.
How do you spell Wahlberg? Is it B-E-R-G or it's B-U-R-G?
With an H?
W-A-H-L-B-E-R-G, I think.
Or is it I'm gonna see if there's an excerpt on Amazon that we can have a dramatic reading of.
Yeah.
It's an E.
And close it out with the 100,000 point drift points track.
I don't think we're closing it out.
Oh,
no,
really?
We got 15
minutes.
Oh,
now that you're thinking about the time, it's going really slow.
I know.
It was blazing before.
I know.
Well, let's speed up with this question. Mel Mills asks, and this is for the room, not just Jeff. I'm opening it to the room. Independence Day 2, Men in Black 3, or Bad Boys 3? What are you looking forward to the
Bad
most?
Bad Boys 3.
Bad Boys 3.
Has Michael Bay ever made a bad
Network
movie?
Network 2.
Yes.
Which one?
The Island.
What's wrong with The Island?
It's bad.
Transformers.
Horrible.
And the other Transformers.
It's bad even for a Michael Bay movie. The first Transformers, while bad, when presented next to the second Transformers, looks like fucking
you're right.
The greatest movie ever made.
I don't know, I kind of like the second Transformers better than the first one. I don't know what that says about me.
My favorite part of the second Transformers is when they go into the Air and Space Museum in Washington and come out into a desert. For no reason. I mean,
my favorite part is when Shia LaBeouf goes to Transformer Heaven. Robot Heaven.
I like the
Alien Robot Heaven.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, it's probably like out of body experience. He's talking to spirits of past primes.
Oh, right. And then he touches the Allspark and
gets lame. It's so stupid. It's amazing.
Yeah.
No, the island, the reason the island is bad is because it is basically parts the Clonus Horror. It is exactly parts the Clonus Horror, which is one of my favorite episodes of MST3K.
Well, it's also like prisonery, like the prisoner.
Sure. But have you seen?
It's the island's one about the clones, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, never mind. It's not at all.
Spoilers. They play future Xbox,
and there are Xbox logos everywhere.
Yeah.
Did they play? I don't remember that at all.
Yeah, they do, but they're not playing Xbox. They're having a virtual reality fight.
God, I don't remember that at all.
And they're all dumb, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because it's okay to kill dead people for their organs. Dumb people.
Yeah.
That's what we got.
Right.
That's what that movie taught me.
That's I knew that going in.
Yes.
I say just fire it off, man.
Wow. We got in here. We got a Knuckles. We got a SpongeBob. We've got a Buzz. Got a Power Ranger. Ah, we got
Reptile.
Got a reptile.
Is that a Ryu with Spider-Man eyes? What am I looking at there?
That's Knuckles.
That's not what I'm.
I don't know which one you're looking at.
Well, now I'm not going to tell.
Oh, okay. Are you talking about the bottom right? Like if the red was his giant headband.
Is he wearing a bow tie?
He's got a little like checkered bow tie though. Ryu would be way cooler if he had a little checkered bow tie.
Yep. He'd fight harder.
Guess what? I want another tip.
Here's another tip. Do you know that an echidna is a real animal? They weren't just making it up for Sonic the Hedgehog.
And if you take echidna when you get sick, the cold lasts not as long.
It's true.
Okay. I'm going to start a feature called Matt Kessler's Pro Tips.
What does tip stand for?
Things I'm playing.
Knights in Satan's service.
Yeah.
Found on Road Dead.
Yeah. Fix it again, Tony.
Fix or repair, Dan.
That car has speed.
But that's Beat, right?
Oh, yeah.
From Jet Set Radio.
No. Isn't it the other one of that?
Jet Set Radio
Jet
Future?
Grind Radio.
The Grind Radio.
They can't call it Jet Set Radio.
Except for when they call it Jet Set Radio Future.
Right.
We don't like to recognize the existence of Jet Grind Radio around these parts.
I don't either.
Because Jet Set Radio is such a better name.
Yeah.
These people have a lot of fire.
Yeah. It's not like Jet Set Radio means anything or makes any sense, but Jet Grind Radio definitely doesn't.
Is this a spiral track, I'm guessing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is a 100,000 drift trophy track.
Seems like you might be running out of spiral.
Then it goes back down.
What do we do when we fall down?
Get back up.
Get back up.
That's what we're talking.
I taught Kessler that. It's a lesson I pulled entirely from my brain without any kind of outside influence whatsoever.
Wow.
You know, just made that up.
Just made it up right then. When Kessler was fucking up. But in a, positive learning way.
Are you guys right? We never should go on this.
This is a terrible idea.
This track.
Yeah.
Also, it's 3 laps.
This is kind of like NASCAR. You just keep turning the same direction over and over again. So do you have to drift 1,001 drift? 100,001 drift?
I think that might be what the trophy is.
Wow.
Will, is this true? Sador Nan, says Microsoft is giving Windows Mobile 7 phones to all 90,000 of its employees.
That is 100% true.
That's at least what they're claiming publicly.
Although if, I got nothing funny to say there.
No, it wasn't.
Don't worry.
Funny.
Don't worry. By the time they actually give all the phones out, there won't be that many employees.
Or Windows 7.
Phone.
No, no.
Windows 7 is good.
Sure.
What do you have against Windows 7?
No, I Windows 7 is fine. I'm saying Windows. Come on.
What, you think we're all going to be running Linux?
I'm pretty impressed by this.
Yes.
This is going.
You're halfway there.
Linux's time change. Is coming.
If you look at the phones, Android is Linux. Oh, this is dangerously close.
Don't.
Oh, no! Oh. We're going to have to do it again. The third lap.
Mill Mills asks, what's a worse name, Fast Five or Five Null Destination?
Oh, God! How did I even...
That's impressive.
I think Five Null Destination is fucking genius. Then I also am...
an idiot.
One of the rare people that really enjoyed the Final Destination film.
So. Like I said, an idiot.
Whatever.
Weren't you talking last time?
You don't know
about
how to enjoy
terrible?
Anything not ironically.
Whatever.
Touché.
I like nachos.
Well said.
I just want to point out that Ryan beat the wall a minute ago.
I did. That stupid wall.
I like hot dogs.
Hot dogs are good. We need to find a good hot dog place around here.
Yeah.
They sell corn dogs at Safeway.
I like early Eazy-E.
Long walks on the beach and pina coladas?
Yeah.
Ladies, you heard it here.
That is the first Eazy-E album. So, yeah.
I'd like an Eazy-E autobiography as well.
Yeah.
I'd read that.
Just come out now. Like he wrote it on his deathbed.
Yeah.
Lil E just found this in his dad's belongings.
The wall wins again.
Written by Marky Mark.
Yes. Marky Mark should write a biography of Eazy-E.
An autobiography.
Yes.
You should channel
he
him.
He is the foremost expert.
Seance. I like that there's geese on the thing. I'm pro cruelty to geese.
Well, geese themselves are pretty cruel, so.
That's why I'm pro cruelty to geese. They bite. I think this track was very bad.
Well, did you get a trophy?
I'm going to buy this game on the way home.
Of course you don't like it.
I gave it one star, though I did kind of enjoy that race.
It's good practice for your drifting.
It's like, let's focus on one aspect of this.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just talk about drifting. How good are you at drifting? I was ninth good. I was the ninth goodest at drifters.
You're nine under par.
No, that'd be, well,
that doesn't.
Because the par doesn't work that way. Go play Tiger Woods, Kessler.
I've never played.
Low numbers are better.
Yeah. I can't connect to the internet.
So ninth under par would be very good.
Ninth under par is Tiger Woods.
We know it must be coming to the end. Because we're talking
rift.
About golf.
What?
Miners Rift. I mean, I'll talk about, you know, Tiger Woods. That's fine. That's not outside of my wheelhouse.
The dude or the game?
The game.
The life.
The life and times of?
The mystery.
Go elite on this one.
I want to see an 8-second lap here. Let's break the world record.
Yeah.
And make that happen.
You owe me a 10-second car.
It's not mine.
Lostro wants to find a Nuremberg track.
Nope.
I've...
Try again?
Try again.
Can I ask again? Fine.
Yeah.
Lostro wants to find a Nuremberg track.
Nope.
All right.
That's not a place. There's no such place as Nuremberg.
No, Nuremberg is a place, but that's not...
Yeah. You don't want a track
that's,
there.
You don't want a track
yeah.
there.
What about the ring?
There is no ring there. Now, if you want to go to the Nuremberg ring... That would be a different story.
Well, what about Nuremberg?
What about Nuremberg?
That's not an appropriate place for that conversation.
I have kind of a serious question.
Okay.
Yeah.
No.
Please.
You know that parking lot across the street?
Yeah.
They
yeah.
put chains or anything up when they close at 6 o'clock?
No, I've used it.
So I can leave the car there indefinitely?
Oh, yeah,
it's
yeah,
there
yeah. you're in a lot. You
yeah,
have
you're
come
good.
Fine.
You're all good.
That's a Kratos.
That is a Kratos.
That's probably like a real Kratos.
Yeah.
Boo. That,
Be original. Use other people's copyrighted material, not Sony's.
That's right.
Well, I'm saying, like, that's actually...
That probably
Sony
comes
probably
with the game.
That.
I know.
So So boo.
I said, this is a pretty good map so far. There's I like how you thought you were going to go up and then you went down. Mm-hmm. That was good.
Is that what you're doing now, Will? You're critiquing tracks?
I'm tested from now on. It's just going to be a review site for Mod Nation Racers tracks.
Yeah, he tested some of the tracks, and now he's putting out his opinion on
it. Right, and Little Big Planet. We're going to take the site down. It's just going to be a front end for star reviews of these tracks.
So tested.com is literally going to become a QA website.
Pretty much.
I missed the memo.
Little Big Tested.
You ever have memos?
We got to work out the business model around this.
Send you a memo.
Wow. Memo? So you're like Double Rainbow?
Yeah, Finding Nemo. All
right. Finding Nemo.
Captain Nemo.
Drew just threw out some trash.
I'd like a Captain Nemo game.
I'd like a Captain EO game.
I'd like both of those games in one.
I just want to play a squid.
Nemo versus EO,
yeah.
The final battle. I also would like to fight a squid.
Thank you.
What about Little Nemo?
That's a game.
That is a game. My blazing hot drifts.
All that practice on the spiral track.
Yep.
Paying off. In spades.
Wall.
Oh, wall.
Spaders. Wall always wins.
Right.
Oh. Man, I thought I was going to hit that wall, too.
Hey, you're third. Oh, wait, no, that's the lap.
Hey, I'm in the third lap.
Hey, you're on the third lap. Yeah.
Congratulations.
Good job.
We're on the third lap, Vinny.
Oh, hey.
Everybody wins.
Hey, Vinny.
Hi, how
are
you doing?
Where
you
been?
Oh, I didn't see you there.
Keep your eyes on the track.
What you been doing?
Wu-Tang.
Listen to a little hip-hop. Playing and watching people play Mod Nation Racers. Making fun of Kessler.
Yeah.
You know, the huge.
Who's winning at Pitch?
Well, at the ladder, we all win.
Woo! I think sixth place is the best finish so far tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That was me. I'm the best Mod Nation Racers player out of us.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to dump these people into one more race.
All right.
We're going to, yeah.
Last race.
We're going to call it.
Last race
of the night. That guy's driving a car that looks like a dog.
I'm going to dump myself.
All right.
What? No, just stay for one more thing.
Bring it home. Race, Dave.
Bring it home, Dave.
Fine.
Fine. We're so close.
Just one more race, Dave.
How am I going to get 10.test.com done on time?
Well, we have no timeline for that, so anytime it's done is on
time. It's live tomorrow.
Yeah.
We've already sold ads.
Midnight tonight. Yeah. Already have ad commitments.
I hope you don't have plans.
Crap.
I mean, if you do, too bad.
I was going to read this book.
But I hope you don't.
We're changing the name of the site from 10.tested.com to Everything's Awesome. The official review site for things that are awesome. P.S. Everything's Awesome.
I don't think we can use the word awesome anymore. I think we've overused it.
As a society?
Yeah, absolutely.
We're moving on to Rad.
So what's
can we
the
bring
new,
Rad back?
What's the new
Rad already came back.
Yeah.
I've been working on Rad for like 10 years. Yeah. I missed it coming back.
Rad, like mid-90s, Rad had its
I'm
turn.
Saying post-Rad, post-mid-90s Rad. I'm saying late 2010s.
Bodacious?
I think it was Bodacious.
Too long.
I want to say I've been saying Rad for the past 10 years, trying to bring Rad back as well. And at some point, it just came back.
The problem
I feel like
is,
at I feel some like point, I just started using it to use it, and not because I wanted other people to say it.
Wicked?
Wicked's pretty good.
Makes
it sound like you're from Massachusetts.
We just
though.
Need to
How about that's pretty boss?
I like boss.
Boss.
I, like
I
boss.
Went through a pretty big boss phase for about 5 years
Blood
ago.
Blood Springsteen?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
The problem is right now it's Win.
He was born to run, that guy.
And I don't want to be in that world anymore.
I think boss is
I don't associate with people who do that.
That
Win?
But they're out there all the time and on the internet.
Well, then don't associate with
them. They're probably fucking cake eaters.
Oh, that's the worst.
Yes.
People who eat cake and talk about winning. Ugh.
I have zero patience.
Epic for the win.
I have zero patience for that. It makes me want to punch Jeff, even though he's saying that derisively.
Yeah. Yes.
Stargamer X says, giant bomb, FTW.
Ugh.
What does FTW stand for?
For the win.
I never heard that before.
I think of it in the wrestling context where I believe it stood for fuck the world.
It's like it's a derivative of FODE, fuck off and die.
Yeah.
No, that was the thing, is I knew FTW as fuck the world for too long before, and I didn't even know it as a wrestling thing.
Just how you felt about things. General worldview.
Yeah.
I just don't
like, a dark turn.
I don't like people applying Hollywood Squares lingo to real life. And then not knowing that it came. Yeah. If people ended all their stupid internet memes with circle gets the square, that'd be way funnier than all this for the
Survey
win.
Survey says circle gets the square.
But isn't all the internet stuff, isn't it like derived from WoW? Isn't that where
Or 4chan and...
Yes. But I bet the whole for the win, isn't it like...
Yeah. I believe the for the win thing. I'm pretty sure someone started saying it because they watched a lot of Hollywood Squares, and then it became totally detached from that.
I'm going to the internet answer machine. I'm going to look it up.
Like, when you accidentally kill yourself in Battlefield Bad Company 2 Online, it comes up with a screen that says Epic Fail. And
that sucks.
Every time that happens.
Well, totally dates the game. It's just everything about it sucks. Everything about that sucks.
Sucks.
Everything about that totally sucks.
Are we doing a reverse?
Jeff, you're correct.
No.
The Urban Dictionary says FTW, or for the win, is an enthusiastic emphasis to the end of a comment message or post, sometimes genuine, but often sarcastic. Originated from the game show Hollywood Squares, where the result of the player's response is expected to win the game. For example, Bob, your 1-Up t-shirt rocks. Sally, 1-Up t-shirts FTW.
I want to hang out and wear game shoes.
Game shoes?
Yes.
I want to hang out with people that edit the Urban Dictionary.
There are 4,000 comments
on that post. Oh, God.
And then there's 35 other different definitions that are less popular.
I don't know. Meme speak is... I mean, I guess silly, like, to begin
it's,
with.
It's at this point, I just feel like it's just a sign of a generational shift.
Sure.
Like the way
back in your day,
the way my dad derisively said "tubular" because he thought it was so dumb is the way that we are now bitching about Epic Fail and For the Win. It's just the kids are into it. It's beyond us now. They're idiots, but that's
we were idiots also.
Yes. On the plus side, Metamucil, awesome for regularity.
F and A.
Every time I take any Metamucil, I just feel like I swallowed a brick. It does not have its intended result.
You're supposed to mix it with water.
Oh.
Yeah, it's not just powder, dude.
I've been smoking it.
That works too.
Does it get you fucked up?
Wasted.
I know what I'm doing tonight.
It's better than eye dosing.
With Metamucil?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Seems like that would be making it hard to blink. Very gritty.
Joe in our chat named Bowser. He's Bowser with a U.
Classy. B-A-U-S-O?
So he's British Bowser?
Bowser. Yeah. Yeah, I'm the Bowser.
There's another accent.
Yeah, Jeff Bowser. I am play for the Atlanta Braves and I am un the dragon.
The princess, you will be mine. I am the Bowser. Oh.
Final lap. Of this nice TNT.
Wants to let you know that he's 18 and he's not into that stuff.
Good for him.
Pierre. Is he replying to my personal ad?
Hold on.
A, I'm 18. B, I'm not into that stuff. Great, let's do this. Like, what?
Be at the bathrooms in the park.
What if your personal ad is, hey, I'm into all this stuff and I'm into people who aren't into that stuff? Then Bowser's perfect for you.
Yeah.
Bowser. So there you go. I do a bad German monotone. Yeah. Turns out.
So I kind of sound like a nihilist from Lebowski.
I guess we're just giggling at chat.
Yeah, no.
Not even sharing anything.
How much beer have you given him?
Like half a one.
Not enough.
Like a Rory amount.
Like a shares.
Yeah.
Oh.
So he's like standing on his chair.
Yep.
Rory's been sitting in a chair in Hall H at Comic-Con for like 14 hours
chat
now.
What are you talking about? He's fighting off Mio San Diego.
That's right. He's either fighting or teaming up with that werewolf that loves the Padres.
Ryan said, right. Basically said, like, did you mean him to be the sidekick or is he the enemy? And I was like, that's actually pretty good.
I'm just happy that after badgering you to put some kind of San Diego Padres gear on one
on some site design.
And I was like, well,
design.
The werewolf is the most obvious.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Naturally.
Oh, that's it.
Can we cut those pink cables up there and see
that's
what they
it.
Do?
Bombs go off.
Cool.
That's right.
So that's red wire. You don't have the bomb.
Well, those used to be red.
Oh, they faded?
Sun faded.
In the basement?
Uh-huh.
Where there's no sun?
Yeah.
Or light, really, whatsoever?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Cool.
That was our last race, gents.
All right.
I was in there. I was in the mix. I was up to third
yeah.
at one point.
Yeah.
And then it all went bad, and I got 10th.
You
so.
Got the giggles.
What are you going to do? I think Kessler got the giggles. Thank you, Kessler, for manning the chat room, though. I appreciate it.
Another job well done,
and, Matt. And Drew Scanlon for keeping it real at the controls. Drew, as always, a pleasure. Professional, your gentleman, and a scholar. And these gentlemen as well, Dave, Jeff, Will, thanks for hanging out on the couch with us.
It was fun.
And us. And them. You at home. Thanks for watching, and thanks everyone who played Mod Nation Racers with us. That's going to do it for this week's edition of Thursday Night Throwdown. We will see you next Thursday.
Wave at the television.
Bye, television. Goodbye, Dave and Ryan's head.
Oh, wait. Oh, it's...
Oh, no. It's still on.
Kessler. Kessler.
Paul Schaefer, everybody. Paul Schaefer.
Next week, he's going to be bald.
Brought to you by Apple.